on the board,
you can see the verse. It's from the Dasa Avatar Stotra, and this is a verse describing the appearance of Lord Ramachandra. So we're going to sing that this verse this morning instead of Jaya Radha Madhava.
आज हामीहरु बोर्डमा लेखिएको दश अवतार स्तोत्र जुन छ त्यो गाउँछौँ जय राधा माधवको सट्टामा
Ditarashi dikshu rame dikpati kamaniyam Dashamukha moli rame bhavaniyam Vitarasi dikshu rame dikpati kamaniyam Dashamukha moli balim ramaniyam Dikpati kamaniyam Dashamukha boli ramin balamiyam Vitarasi dikshu rame Dikpati kamaniyam Dashamukha boli balim ramaniyam Kesha Bhadrita Rama Sharira Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare
Kesha Bhadrita
Bhadrita Rama Sharira Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Vitarasi dikshu rame dikpati kamaniyam Dashamukha moli balim ramaniyam Vitarasi dikshu rame dikpati kamaniyam Dashamukha moli balim ramaniyam Vitarasi dikshu rame dikpati kamaniyam Dashamukha moli balim ramaniyam
Vitarasi dikshu rame dikpati kamaniyam Dashamukha moli balim ramaniyam
Bhadrita Rama Sharira Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Bhadrita Rama Sharira Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Bhadrita Rama Sharira Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Vitarasi dikshu rame dikpati ramaniyam Dashamukha polim avim ramaniyam
Vitarasi dikshu rame dikpati ramaniyam Dashamukha polim avim ramaniyam
Vicharasi dikshu rame dikpati kamaniyam Dashamukha moli palim ramaniyam Bhadrita Rama Sharira Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Bhadrita Rama Sharira Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam namaskrityam.
Narayanam namaskrityam.
Naram chaiva narottamam.
Naram chaiva narottamam.
Daivim sarasvatim vyasam.
Daivim sarasvatim vyasam.
Tato jaya mudiraya.
Tato jaya mudiraya.
Nasta praeshu vajreshu.
Nasta praeshu vajreshu.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke.
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke.
Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki.
Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki.
There are two chapters. So in Srimad Bhagavatam, in the ninth canto, there are two chapters relating the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra.
Srimad Bhagavatam, Navam Skandama, there are two chapters Jasma Bhagavan Sri Ramachandra ko barema batayeko cha.
The first chapter is about the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra.
Pahilo adhyaya ho Bhagavan Sri Ramachandra ko lila katharu.
And the second chapter, chapter 11, describes how Lord Ramachandra ruled the world.
Ra dosro adhyaya 11 adhyaya ma Bhagavan Ramachandra le kasari sansar ma shasan chalaunu bhayo bhanne barema cha.
So Lord Ramachandra was born, he appeared in the line of the Kshatriya kings coming from the sun god.
Bhagavan Ramachandra Surya Vamsi Raja Haruko Vamsama Aunu Bhayeko Thiyo.
Lord Krishna, he is coming from the in the line from the moon god.
Bhagavan Krishna Chandra Vamsama Aunu Bhayeko Thiyo.
Right, Krishna was born, appeared on the Ashtami, the eighth day. But it described the moon was so happy that Krishna was appearing in his dynasty that the moon appeared full that day.
Ra Bhagavan Krishna Ashtami ko din ma aunu bhayeko thiyo ra yesto ullekh gariyeko cha ki chandrama eti khushi hununthyo ashtami ko din ma nai purna chandrama udaunu bhayeko thiyo.
So Lord Ramachandra was appearing in the line from the sun god, and the great king Katvanga Maharaj was one of the forefathers of Lord Ramachandra.
Ramchandra chai Katvanga Maharaj Ramchandra ko chai purvaj hununthyo.
Katvanga was also a great devotee. He was the person who had gone to the heavenly planets to fight on behalf of the demigods against the demons.
Ra wahale Katvanga Maharaj le devi devta haruko pakshe bada rakshas haruko viruddha ma yuddha garnu bhayeko thiyo.
And the demigods were so thankful to him that they gave him a blessing that he could ask anything from them.
Ra devi devta haru waha bata eti prasanna hununthyo ki वहाँलाई तपाईलाई जे आशीर्वाद चाहिएको छ हामी त्यो दिन्छौ भनेर भन्नुभयो.
So Katvanga Maharaj asked the demigods, just tell me, how long do I have left in this life? How much time do I have left in my body before I leave the body?
वहाँले भन्नुभयो देवी देवताहरूलाई कि भन्नुस् मलाई अब म यो शरीरमा कति धेरै समय रहनु पर्छ भन्ने कुरा जिज्ञासा गर्नुभयो.
Wouldn't we like to know how long we have?
तपाईहरुलाई म कति बाँच्छु भनेर जान्न चाहनुहुन्छ?
Would we be worried if we thought, oh, I don't have much time left?
तपाईहरुलाई ओहो मेरो धेरै समय छैन भन्ने भयो भने चिन्ता लाग्छ कि लाग्दैन?
Maharaj Katvanga was told, you have one moment left.
र महाराज खटवाङ्गलाई भनिएको थियो तपाईँको त एक क्षण मात्र बाँकी छ अब.
Would we panic if we heard that? Only one moment. Oh no.
अब ओहो मेरो एकै छिन मात्र बाँकी रहेछ भनेर हामीलाई एकदम चिन्ता लाग्छ होला नि होइन.
So Khatvanga Maharaj, when he heard he had one moment, he immediately came back to this planet Earth and he fixed his mind on the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord.
जबकि खटवाङ्ग महाराजले एकै क्षण मात्र मेरो जीवनावधि बाँकी छ भन्ने थाहा पाउने बित्तिकै यो पृथ्वी तलमा आउनुभयो र भगवानको चरण कमलमा ध्यान मग्न हुनुभयो.
And because he fixed his mind on the Lord, at the end of his life, he went back to the Supreme Lord. He got freed from material life.
र यसरी भगवानको चरण कमलमा पूर्ण ध्यान लगाउनु भएको हुनाले उहाँको जीवनको अन्तमा भगवानको धाममा प्रवेश गर्नुभयो.
So Lord Ramachandra, he appears in the line of a great king like Khatvanga.
र यसरी भगवान रामचन्द्र महान राजा खटवाङ्ग जस्ता राजाहरूको वंशमा आउनुभएको थियो.
And the father of Lord Ramachandra was also a great king. His name was Dasara.
र भगवान रामचन्द्रको पिता हुनुहुन्थ्यो उहाँ पनि यस्तै महान राजा हुनुहुन्थ्यो जसको नाम दशरथ थियो.
He was a very pious king who was known for his truthfulness.
र उहाँ एकदम पवित्र राजा हुनुहुन्थ्यो उहाँ सत्यवादी राजा भनेर चिनिनुहुन्थ्यो.
Right, there's a statement in Ramayana. Ragukuli rakshalai pranjayarun vachanajai. That if I would rather give up my life than tell a lie.
Ra Ramayan ma euta vachan cha ki ragukul ma chahe pran jaos tara vachan bhane khera jane chaina bhanni bhanai cha.
Nowadays if people have to tell the truth they would die.
Ra hija aja manish haru hamiharu satya bolnu ko satta baru marna tayar hunchau hami satya bolnainau.
But Maharaj Dasarath was such a great soul, he was vowed to truthfulness.
Ra Maharaj Dasarath eti mahan hununthyo ki wa satya bolna ko lagi drid pratigya hununthyo.
So Lord Ramachandra appeared as the son of Dasarath and he had three brothers, Lakshman, Bharat and Shatrughna.
Ra Maharaj Ramchandra Bhagwan Dasarath ko jun परिवारमा आउनुभयो उहाँको तीन दाजुभाइहरू लक्ष्मण अनि भरत अनि शत्रुघ्न तीन भाइ हुनुहुन्थ्यो उहाँका.
सो लर्ड रामचन्द्र इज द सुप्रीम लर्ड हिमसेल्फ.
भगवान रामचन्द्र उहाँ आफै भगवान हुनुहुन्छ.
एन्ड द थ्री ब्रदर्स लक्ष्मण भरत एन्ड शत्रुघ्न दे आर ऑल इन्कार्नेशन्स अफ द लर्ड्स एक्सपेन्शन्स.
र रामचन्द्र भगवान र उहाँका तीन भाइहरू उहाँको विस्तार हुनुहुन्छ.
जस्ट लाइक द क्वाड्रुपल फॉर्म्स अफ द लर्ड्स वासुदेव संकर्षण अनि रुद्र प्रद्युम्न. सो दिस फोर ब्रदर्स आर नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दिस एक्सपेंशन.
र जसरी चतुर्थ भगवानको विस्तारहरूमा संकर्षण वसुदेव अनुरुद्र प्रद्युम्न भने जस्तै भगवानका यी अंश विस्तारहरूमा हुनुहुन्छ.
So the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra, of course, they are described in detail in the Ramayana by people like Valmiki.
र भगवान रामचन्द्रको यी लीला कथाहरू रामायणमा वाल्मीकि मुनिले बताउनु भएको छ.
That is the actual Ramayana, the authorized version of Ramayana. It's the one written by Valmiki, not the one by Tulsidas.
र यसरी वाल्मीकि मुनिले लेख्नुभएको व्याख्या गर्नुभएको रामायण चाहिँ अत्यन्त प्रामाणिक हो र तुलसीदास अनि अरूहरूले पनि लेख्नुभएको छ तर त्यति प्रामाणिक मानिँदैन.
So in the Ramayana is this the pastimes of Lord Rama are described extensively. Here in Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Goswami is only describing them in brief.
र रामायणमा भगवान रामचन्द्रको कथा यसरी पूर्ण रूपमा व्याख्या गरिएको छ र यहाँ श्रीमद् भागवतममा थोरै मात्र व्याख्या गरिएको छ.
Sukadeva Goswami has to instruct Maharaj Parikshit about the goal of life.
र सुखदेव गोस्वामीले महाराज परीक्षितलाई जीवनको अन्तिम लक्ष्यको बारेमा बताउनु परेको हुन्छ।
And both Sukadeva Goswami and Maharaj Parikshit are devotees of Lord Krishna, and they're inclined to hear about Krishna.
Ra Sukadeva Goswami ra Maharaj Parikshit dui jane Bhagwan Krishna ka bhakta hununcha ra waha haru Bhagwan Krishna ko barema badi sunna ra katha garna ichhuk hununcha.
It is Lord Krishna who is the supreme personality of Godhead, and when he comes in this world, Lord Krishna displays the pastimes of the Supreme Lord.
Ra Bhagwan Sri Krishna Purna Purushottam Bhagwan hununcha tesele jaba waha yo sansar ma aunu huncha ra apna purna lila adi vyakta garnu huncha.
Lord Ramachandra, he is coming to play the part of a perfect king, to show how a king should rule and how he should lead the people and how he should teach by his example.
र भगवान रामचन्द्र एकजना एकदम पूर्ण राजाको अभिनय गर्न आउनुभएको थियो। उहाँले कसरी एउटा आदर्श राजाले राज्य चलाउनु पर्छ, कसरी उहाँले आफ्नो जीवन आदि पक्का रूपमा चलाउनु पर्छ भन्ने कुरा त्यहाँ बताइएको छ।
लर्ड रामचन्द्र इज डिस्क्राइब्ड एज बीइङ मर्यादा अवतार, मीन्स ही इज परफेक्ट इन हिज बिहेवियर. And he strictly follows all the etiquette in dealing with his superiors and his parents and his gurus and all these kind of people.
Ra Bhagavan Ramchandra lai maryada purushottam ko avatar ko rupma linchha. Waha le kasari purna rupma aafu bhanda agraj vyakti haru sanga vyavahar garne ani aafu sarakar ra anya anya vyakti haru sanga अनि प्रजा आदि सबैसँग कसरी व्यवहार गर्ने भन्ने कुरा राम्ररी देखाउनुहुन्छ।
लर्ड रामचन्द्र डिस्प्लेज द परफेक्ट क्यारेक्टर, एन्ड श्रील प्रभुपाद अफ्टन डिस्क्राइब आवर कृष्ण कन्शियसनेस मुभमेन्ट इज मेन्ट फर ट्रेनिङ द डिभोटिज दट वी विल अल्सो डेभलप आवर परफेक्ट क्यारेक्टर।
र भगवान रामचन्द्रलाई एकदम सच्चावान चरित्रको रूपमा, पूर्ण राम्रो चरित्र भएको व्यक्तिको रूपमा हेरिन्छ। र त्यसैले श्रील प्रभुपादले पनि भक्तहरूलाई त्यस्तै रामचन्द्रको जस्तो राम्रो व्यवहारहरू, चरित्रहरू विकास गर्नको लागि आग्रह गर्नुभएको छ।
So while Lord Ramachandra was still a young man, not yet married, still young in his father's home, at that time the palace of Maharaj Dasaras was visited by Vishwamitra.
Ra jabaki Bhagwan Ramchandra sanai umer ma hununthyo tete bela Dasarath ko darbar ma hununthyo ra Valmiki muni le Vishwamitra muni le maaf garnus Vishwamitra muni le waha lai darbar ma milna aunu bhayeko thiyo.
Vishwamitra was a great sage living in the forest, and he was being troubled by some rakshasas who were disturbing his practice of sacrifices, yagyas.
Ra Vishwamitra muni jangal ma basnu hunthyo ra waha mahan rishi hununthyo ra waha lai bibhinna kisim ka rakshas haru le waha ko yagya haru ma badha vyavadhan lyaune gardache.
Whenever Vishwamitra would perform yagyas, this rakshasa would appear and he'd pass stool and blood and urine and things on the sacrificial fire, polluting everything.
Jabaki Vishwamitra muni tyaha yagya garnu hunthyo teti bela rakshas haru le mal mutra haru visarjan garne ragat haru esta esta naramra kura haru chai tyaha laera unharule phalne adi kaam gardathe.
So when Vishwamitra came to the palace of Maharaj Dasarath, Maharaj Dasarath received him, saying, he addressed him with great respect, "O great sage who is conquering over death, how can I serve you?"
Ra jab Vishwamitra muni Dasarath raja ko darbar ma palnu bhayo teti bela raja Dasarath le Vishwamitra muni lai bado aadar ka sath waha ko उहाँलाई उहाँको सत्कार गर्नुभयो र भन्नुभयो, ए महान ऋषि, तिमी जो चाहिँ आफ्नो मृत्युको पकडमा हुनुहुन्न, तपाईँ जस्तो ऋषिलाई मैले के सेवा गरौँ भनेर भन्नुभयो।
our Krishna consciousness movement is also meant for training us to conquer over death.
हाम्रो कृष्ण भावनामृत जुन अभियान छ यसमा पनि हामीहरूले हामीहरूलाई कसरी मृत्युमाथि विजय पाउने भनेर यसमा हामीहरूलाई तालिम दिएको दिनको लागि पनि हो.
So Vishwamitra was very happy to hear these nice words from the king. So then he told the king that he had come because he wanted Maharaj Dasarath's son, Lord Ramachandra, to go with them to kill some rakshasas.
Ra Vishwamitra muni le pani aapu aunu bhayeko kura jun Dasarath lai ujagar gardai bhannuhuncha ki waha le Dasarath ka jun putra haru chan waha haruko lagi aunu bhayeko thiyo jasle jun yagya ma vidhamsa garne rakshas haru lai mrityu ko mukha purai dinu huncha.
Now Maharaj Dasarath was very attached to his son. He didn't want him to go. He thought, you know, he's my most dear son, that if he has to go and fight some rakshasa, something may happen, he may be harmed.
Ra Maharaj Dasarath apna putra haru prati bado asakta hunuhunthyo ra wahale sochnu bhayo ki oho inerlai patai bhane rakshasharle inerlai dukha dinchan pida dinchan bhanera wahale yesari sochnu bhayo.
Vishwamitra was very firm in his mood. He said, no, your son has to come. Maharaj Dasarath said, let me go. I will go. I will fight this rakshasa. Vishwamitra said, no, Ram, I want your son, Lord Rama. He should come with me.
Jati vela Dasarath Raja le hoina ma janchu baru inera navanus bhannuhuntyo ra teti vela ma Vishwamitra muni le pani आफ्नो वचनमा यति प्रतिज्ञा दृढ हुनुहुन्थ्यो कि होइन मलाई रामचन्द्र नै तपाईँको पुत्रहरू नै चाहिन्छ तपाईँ होइन भनेर यसरी पक्का पक्की कुराकानी भएको थियो.
So Maharaj Dasarath was very worried how to keep his word, his promise that he was promising to serve Vishwamitra, to give him whatever he wanted, and now he didn't want to give his son. So he didn't want to break his vow of truthfulness.
र यति बेला विश्वामित्र मुनिलाई राजा दशरथले पहिला नै भन्नुभएको थियो कि म तपाईँका तपाईँले माग्नुभएको कुरा जे पनि दिन्छु भन्नुभएको थियो तर अहिले उहाँ सङ्कटमा पर्नुभयो कि मैले भनिसकेको वचन अब कसरी दिन्न भन्नु उहाँलाई आफ्नो सत्यवादिता प्रमाणित गर्न पनि कठिन थियो.
So Lord Rama went with Vishwamitra, and Lakshman also accompanied Lord Rama because Lakshman was a younger brother and he was deeply attached to his older brother.
Ra teti bela Ramchandra lai Vishwamitra muni le liera janu bhayo ra Lakshman pani sath mai janu bhayo kina bhane Lakshman aafno daju Ramchandra prati ekdam asakta hunuhunthyo.
So they went with Vishwamitra, and Vishwamitra gave them both he taught them all the mantras to release different weapons by mantras so that they could fight these demons. And Lord Rama and Lakshman, they went there and they killed this demon Marichi, who had been giving so much trouble.
Ra jati bela Vishwamitra muni le Ramchandra ra Lakshman le liera janu bhayeko thiyo waha le dui jane lai विभिन्न किसिमका शस्त्र अस्त्रहरू र तिनीहरूलाई चलाउने मन्त्र आदि लगायत सबै कुराहरू सिकाउनु भएको थियो र एकजना मरिची भन्ने राक्षसले यज्ञमा विध्वंस ल्याउँथे तिनलाई भगवान् रामचन्द्रले पछि गएर वध गर्नुभयो.
So this was Lord Rama beginning his pastimes as a Kshatriya king. He killed the first rakshasa. There were many, many rakshasas in those days.
Ra teti bela dherai dherai rakshasaru bhaye tapani Bhagwan Ramchandra le aafno ek raja ko bhumika nibhaudai pahilo euta rakshas marichi lai vadh garera aafno lila shuru garnu bhayeko thiyo.
And these rakshasas generally all lived in the forest, but the great sages also lived in the forest, so they would always give trouble to the sages.
र त्यति बेला ती सबै राक्षसहरू जङ्गलमा निवास गर्थे भने महान ऋषिहरूको पनि वासस्थान जङ्गल थियो र ऋषि मुनिहरूलाई राक्षसहरूले पूर्ण रूपमा कष्ट तुल्याउने गर्दथे.
So then, after some time, there came the appearance of Mother Sita from the earth, and then her father, Maharaj Janaka, he understood the great power of his daughter Sita, that she is a very special woman, young woman. So he wants to find a suitable, qualified man for his daughter.
अनि जति बेला सीता महारानी धरतीबाट प्रकट हुनुभयो र उहाँका पिता जनक महाराजले आफ्नो छोरी सीता धेरै विशेष नारी भएको र साधारण नभएको अनि धेरै शक्तिशाली भएको आदि कुरा उहाँलाई ज्ञान भएको थियो.
So Janak was also a great king, and he had in his palace, he had the bow of Lord Shiva, which was so heavy, it took 300 men to pick it up.
Janak Maharaj pani sadharan hununnathyo, mahan raja hununthyo, ra wahako darbar ma shiva dhanush thiyo, to chai teen sai bhanda badi manisharule ek patak uchalna sakte dherai garam thiyo.
But one day Janak saw that his daughter Sita on her own could pick up the bow and move the bow.
Ra ek din raja Janak le dekhnu bhayo ki Sita le to dhanush lai aafai le eklai sarna saknu hunthyo, chalna saknu hunthyo.
So Janak Maharaj arranged a contest that whoever could pick up the bow of Lord Shiva and bend the bow to release an arrow, then they would get the hand of his daughter Sita for a wife.
Ra ek patak Maharaj Janak le thulo ayojana garnu bhayo ra bhannu bhayo ra jasle yo Shiva dhanush lai uchalna sakcha ra tesle nai Sita lai vivaha garna sakcha bhanera esto kura chalaunu bhayo.
So many of the great kings, they heard that this girl Sita, she is very special, she's very beautiful, and she's the daughter of the great King Janak, and she is also very powerful. So many, many great kings all came to take part in the contest, but none of them could pick up the bow of Lord Shiva.
Ra jati bela yo kura sabai tira phailyo, thula thula aru aru raja harle pani yo kura suneka thiye ra uniharulai thaha thiyo ki Sita bhaneko chan chune mahila hainan, eta mahan mahila hun ra भनेर उनीहरूलाई पनि सायद सीता महारानीको हात पाइन्छ कि भन्ने आशले सबैजना त्यो सम्मेलनमा आफू विशेष भन्ने अभिलाषाले उपस्थित हुनुहुन्थ्यो.
एन्ड इवन ग्रेट पावरफुल किङ्स, दे वुड कम एन्ड दे वुड स्ट्रगल ट्राइ टु पिक अप द बो व्हिच युजुअली टुक 300 men टु पिक इट अप. दे कुड हार्डली लिफ्ट इट, एन्ड दे पिक इट अप एन्ड ड्रप इट, दे कुड नॉट होल्ड इट.
र चाहे जतिसुकै शक्तिशाली राजाहरू महाराजाहरू आए तापनि उनीहरूले त्यो धनुषलाई कतिले त हल्लाउन पनि सकेनन्, कतिले बल्ल बल्ल उचाल्न मात्र खोजे जस्तो नभइकन त्यो धनुष भैँमा थचारिहाल्थ्यो, उनीहरूले त्यसलाई डेग पनि लाउन सकेनन्.
But Lord Ramachandra came there, and he easily picked up the bow, and he strung the bow, and then he bent the bow and it broke.
र जति बेला भगवान् रामचन्द्र आउनुभयो र त्यो शिव धनुषलाई सजिलैसँग हातमा उठाउनु भयो र त्यसमा ताँदो चढाउँदै हुनुहुन्थ्यो र त्यति बेला त्यो धनुष ठुलो आवाज निस्केर भाँचियो.
So this bow had actually, it was the bow of Lord Shiva, and it had been given to Parasuram, and somehow from Parasuram it came to the palace of Maharaj Janak. And when Parasuram heard that bow had been broken, then he was very angry.
Ra tyo bela ma to jun Shiva dhanush thiyo, to Shiva ji le to dhanush Parasuram lai dinu bhayeko thiyo, ra Parasuram le yo khabar mero dhanush bhanchiyo bhanne jaba sunnu bhayeko thiyo, waha ekdam krodhit hunu bhayo.
And Parasuram is also Shaktyavesha avatar, he's one of the incarnations of God. He was empowered to kill the Kshatriya race 21 times.
Ra Parashuram pani सत्यवेश अवतार हुनुहुन्थ्यो भगवानको र त्यसैले उहाँलाई क्षेत्रियहरूलाई 21 पटक विनाश गर्नको लागि उहाँलाई शक्ति प्रदान गरिएको थियो.
So he came to see who broke that bow. He came to before Lord Ramachandra. But Lord Ramachandra is far superior to Parasuram. And Parasuram had to go back and retreat. He could not do anything to Lord Ram.
र जब परशुराम रिसाएर आउनुभएको थियो कसले यो धनुष भाँच्यो भन्दै त्यति बेला रामचन्द्रको अगाडि आउनुभयो र उहाँले रामचन्द्रलाई खासै केही गर्न सक्नु भएन किनकि रामचन्द्र धेरै धेरै महान हुनुहुन्थ्यो परशुराम भन्दा पनि.
So this way, Lord Ramachandra was married to Mother Sita. They became husband and wife. And then Maharaj Dasarath was so happy that his son has got such a beautiful wife, and all the people in the kingdom, they all loved him. And Maharaj Dasarath was thinking, I am getting old now, so I will give up the throne and let Lord Ram and Sita become the king and queen and rule the kingdom.
भगवान रामचन्द्रको विवाह भएको थियो र त्यसपछि दशरथ राजा पनि हो मेरो छोराले कस्तो राम्रो सीतालाई बिहा गर्न पाउनुभयो भनेर धेरै प्रसन्न हुनुहुन्थ्यो. सबैजनाहरू आनन्दित हुनुहुन्थ्यो, खुसी हुनुहुन्थ्यो. र जबकि दशरथ राजाले अब म यो राजपाट सबै मेरा पुत्रलाई सुम्पन्छु भन्ने निर्णयमा पुग्नुभएको थियो.
So it was announced to all the kingdom that tomorrow will be the coronation of Lord Rama. He will become the king. So all the citizens in Ayodhya were all very happy. It was going to be a great day, a big festival.
र यसरी दशरथले ठुलो सबैतिर झ्याली पिटाउनु भयो र भन्नुभयो ल भोलि रामचन्द्रको राज्य अभिषेक हुन्छ, सबैजनाहरू पाल्नुहोला र भनेर राज्य अभिषेकको बारेमा उहाँले विज्ञापन गर्नुभएको थियो.
But then there was one hunchback lady working in the palace of Maharaj Dasarath, a very evil mind.
र एकजना अलिकति ढाडको प्रियकी एकजना अलि दुष्ट स्वभावकी महिला पनि त्यही राज्यमा काम गर्ने एउटा सुसारे थिइन्.
And so she came to one of Maharaj Dasarath's queens. Maharaj Dasarath had three queens. He came to Kaikeyi and he told this wife of Maharaj Dasarath, Kaikeyi, that your son Bharat should be the king, not Ram.
Ra tinle aera raja ka teen rani haru mate ek jana rani Kaikeyi le aera bhanin ki रामचन्द्र यो राज्यको राजा होइन, तिम्रो छोरा भरत चाहिँ यसको लागि योग्य छ भनेर रानीलाई उक्साउने आदि काम गर्न लागि.
And she said, if Ram becomes the king, then Bharat won't have any position. He won't be important. He will be just a servant of Ram, and it won't be good for you either. You're his mother, so you won't have any important position.
र जति बेला उनले यदि रामचन्द्र राजा हुनुभयो भने भरत त केवल रामचन्द्रको सेवक मात्र हुन्छन् र यसरी सेवकको आमा हुनाले तपाईँको खासै ठुलो स्थान पनि हुँदैन, त्यो भएर तपाईँको छोरा भरत भएमा तपाईँको राम्रो स्थान हुन्छ आदि इत्यादि भन्न लागिन्.
But Kaikeyi said, what to do? It's already announced. Tomorrow Ram's to become the king. How can I do anything about it?
र कहिले कहिले अब के गर्ने त, भोलि रामचन्द्र राजा बन्नुहुन्छ भनेर पहिल्यै सबैतिर कुराकानी भइसक्यो, अब यसको बारेमा के गरिराख्नु पर्यो भन्ने खाले कुरा उहाँले गर्नुहुन्थ्यो.
But then Kaikeyi told her, said, do you remember that one time Maharaj Dasarath was in trouble in the battle and you came there and you helped him and you saved him and he gave you a boon that you could ask any time for any for boon. Yeah, he gave you two boons. You could ask from him these boons. And you didn't want them at that time. You said, in the future, if I need them, I will ask. So now is the time you use these boons.
र त्यति बेला अनि उनले अझ सम्झाउँदै भनिन् कि थाहा छ तिमीलाई, जति बेला दशरथ राजा ठुलो युद्धमा संकटमा पर्नु भएको थियो त्यति बेला तिमीले आएर दशरथलाई विशेष तवरले यसरी सहयोग गरेर बचाएकी थियौ र त्यति बेला दशरथले खुसी भएर जे चाहिन्छ जे इच्छा छ मलाई भन भन्दाखेरि दुईवटा आशीर्वाद माग्नु भनेर भन्दाखेरि अनि त्यति बेला तिमीले अहिले होइन म जब जरुरी पर्छ तब मागुला भनेको थियौ त्यो समय चाहिँ अहिले नै हो त्यो समयलाई युज गर्नुपर्छ उपयोग गर्नुपर्छ भनेर भन्न थाल्नुभयो.
So Kaikeyi went into mourning. She went into a mood of mourning. She didn't want to see her husband. And Maharaj Dhatharas was very worried. What is wrong with Kaikeyi, my dear wife? And he came to see her. And at that time, then Kaikeyi told her husband that, remember, you were to give me 2 boons. Now I want those boons.
र त्यसपछि कैकेयीले आफूले ठुलो चिन्ता व्यक्त गर्न थालिन् र चिन्तित र व्याकुल अवस्थामा आएको र दशरथ राजासँग कुराकानी गर्न नमानेको आदि देख्दाखेरि दशरथ राजाले ओहो मेरी प्यारी रानी तिमीलाई के भयो किन यस्तो भनेर चाहिँ सम्झाइ बुझाइ गर्न थाल्नुभयो र त्यति बेला कैकेयीले भनिन् तिमीलाई याद छ जति बेला मैले दुईवटा जुन आशीर्वाद माग्छु भनेको थिएँ ती आशीर्वाद मलाई अहिले तपाईँले दिनुपर्छ भनेर भन्न लागिन्.
So Maharaj Dasarath said, yes, you have to, I give you 2 boons. Tell me what you want, whatever you want, I'll be glad to give you.
र दशरथ राजाले त्यही बेला भन्नुभयो ठिकै छ तिमीले दुईवटा आशीर्वाद भनेको थियो त्यो जहिले सुके जुन सुकै बेला मागे नि म दिइहाल्छु के चाहिन्छ जे सुके माग के भएर यसमा भनेर भन्नुभयो.
So then she said, the first boon is, I want Ram should go to the forest and live in the forest for 14 years and let my son Bara become the king.
र पहिलो चाहिँ यो जुन तपाईँले दिनुपर्ने आशीर्वाद के हो भने रामचन्द्रलाई 14 वर्ष वनवासमा पठाइयोस् र मेरो छोरा भरतलाई राजा बनाइयोस्.
You see, when we're in the bodily concept of life, how it brings so many problems. All the problems in the world are caused because of a lack of Krishna consciousness.
Ra la esari hernus ta aba hami sharirik star ma aera hamiharle yo chetana ma rahda kheri kati dherai samasya haru hunchan kati bigna badha haru hunchan.
Because we're thinking in terms of I, just like Kaikeyi was thinking, my son, I want for my son.
र त्यस्तै हामीहरूले यो अवस्थामा म अनि मेरोको भावना विकास गर्छौँ जस्तो कहिले म अनि मेरो छोरा भनेर यसरी भारतको कुरा आदिमा गरेकी थिइन्.
So reluctantly Maharaj Dhatharas had to agree, he had to give these boons to Kaikeyi and he had to tell Lord Ramachandra, I don't want you to be the king now, I want you to go to the forest.
Ra aba karan yahi karan bas Dasharath raja le badhyata bas nai Ramchandra lai gaera bhannu paryo ki timi aba timilai ma aba raja banauna chahanna timi aba banavas jau bhanera bhannu bhayo.
And Lord Ramachandra is a very obedient son. He said, yes, father, whatever you order, I will do.
Ra Ramchandra le aapno pitaji le je bhannu bhayo turanta nai euta aagyakari putra ko rupma huncha pitaji tapai le je bhannu huncha ma tapai ko aadesh manna tayar chu bhannu bhayo.
So this was a big change that he was at one point he's supposed to be the king and the next minute he has to go and live in the forest for 14 years.
र यो एउटा ठुलो परिवर्तनको समय थियो र एकै क्षण अगाडि उहाँ राजा बन्ने तयारीमा हुनुहुन्थ्यो र एकै क्षण पछाडि नै उहाँले अब जङ्गलमा गएर समय बिताउनु पर्ने अवस्थामा पुग्नु भएको थियो.
So when Lord Rama told his wife Sita he was going to the forest, then she said, I also want to come with you.
र त्यति बेला जब सीता महारानीलाई रामचन्द्रले भन्नुभयो कि म अब जङ्गलमा जानुपर्ने भयो भनेर भन्नुभएपछि उहाँले भन्नुभयो ठिक छ म पनि तपाईँसँगै आउँछु भनेर भन्नुभयो.
She didn't want to leave her husband and Lord Rama had to reluctantly agree to allow Mother Sita to accompany him. And then Lakshman also, his dear younger brother, he also wanted to come.
Ara jabaki Sita Maharani le pani ma janchu bhanera bhannu bhaye pachi Ramchandra Bhagwan le wahalai swikar garnu parne bhayo ra sangai janu parne bhayo ra jati bela Lakshman le pani huncha ma pani dai sangai janchu bhanera jane prayas garnu bhayo.
So the next day, instead of the coronation, the three of them got on a chariot, dressed in tree bark, and went off to live in the forest.
र भोलिपल्ट नै तीन जना वहाँहरूले राजा बन्नेको सट्टामा जंगलका रुख आदि आदिको बोक्राको कपडा लगाएर वहाँहरू जंगलतर्फ प्रस्थान गर्न.
Of course, this broke the heart of Maharaj Dasarath, who loved his son Lord Ram more than his own life.
Ra avashya nai yo kura le Dasarath Raja ko hriday chhiya chhiya bhayeko thiyo kinaki waha le Ramchandra lai aafai bhanda pani badi maya garnu hunthyo.
After Lord Rama left for the forest, Maharaj Dasarath was. He remembered a curse which had been put on him when he was a young man.
Ra teti bela Dasarath Raja le aafno euta shrap pareko thiyo jaba waha yuva avastha ma hununthyo tei shrap lai waha le teti bela yaad garnu bhayo.
Maharaj Dasarath remembered that as a young man, one day he was on a hunting expedition and he heard. He was very expert in firing arrows, that he could hit a target just by hearing the sound. He didn't need to see the object. So he heard a sound one day when he was hunting and he released the arrow and he was surprised that when the arrow struck, then he heard a human voice cry out. He thought it was an animal, but it was actually a human.
युवा अवस्थामा छँदा जति बेला दशरथ महाराज तीर चलाउने यो विद्यामा अत्यन्त निपुण हुँदै जानुभएको थियो र उहाँले केवल देखेर होइन आवाजको भरमा नै तीर चलाएर यसरी शिकार गर्न सक्नुहुन्थ्यो र एक दिन यसै गरी यही कम्पिटिसनमा निस्किँदाखेरि उहाँले आवाजको भरमा बाण चलाउनु भएको थियो तर त्यो बाँडले जब लाग्यो त्यति बेला जनावरको सट्टा मानिसको आवाज सुन्नुभएको थियो.
The young man of Maharaj Dasarath went there and found this young man. He said, why did you strike me? Why did you fire an arrow at me? I'm only collecting water for my old parents. They're nearby and they're both blind and helpless and I am taking care of them. And you have put this arrow in me. I'm dying now. I won't be able to go to them. So I request you please go to my mother and father and tell them what has happened. And in this way, the young man died, gave up his life.
Ra teti bela jab baan ko vedana ek jana bakar ka jawan manishma pareko thiyo ra जब दशरथ त्यहाँ पुग्नुभयो र ती मानिसले भने कि ओहो तपाईँले मलाई किन यसरी बाण हान्नुभएको म त केवल मेरो माता पिताको सेवाको लागि यहाँ पानी मात्र भर्न आएको थिएँ अब मेरो माता पिताको सेवा गर्न कसले सक्छ किनकि उहाँ दुईजना अन्धा हुनुहुन्छ उहाँहरू यहीँ नजिक हुनुहुन्छ मैले उहाँहरूको सेवा गर्नुपर्ने अब तपाईँले गएर उहाँहरूलाई भनिदिनुहोस् कि म त अब जान पनि सक्दिनँ तपाईँले भनिदिनुहोस् मलाई यस्तो भयो भनेर ती बालकको निधन भयो.
So Maharaj Dasarath went and he found this old couple and they were both blind, they were sitting waiting and when he came in they spoke, is that you son? Is this our son who has returned with water for us? And Maharaj Dasarath had to say, no, I'm sorry, your son will not be coming anymore. I have killed him by mistake.
Ra teti bela jabaki Dasharatha raja ti manisharlai khojdai jada bhetaunu bhayo ra ani ti ti dui jana briddha dampati haru hununthyo waharle aankha dekhnu hudaina thiyo ra waharle jaba koi byakti aaye jasto lagera तिमी मेरो छोरा आएको हो पानी लिएर आयो बाबु भनेर भन्दाखेरि अनि दशरथ राजाले भन्नु परेको थियो कि होइन तपाईँको छोरा म होइन तपाईँको छोरा अब फेरि अब कहिले पानी लिएर आउँदैनन् किनभने मेरो गल्ती भुल चुकमा मैले उहाँको हत्या गरेँ भनेर भन्नुहुन्छ
So the old couple both cried knowing of the death of their son and then the blind man spoke to Maharaj Dasarath And told him, he said, now we will both give up our life. We will both enter into fire because our son is no longer here with us. We have no purpose in living. So we will both give up our life. And he told Maharaj Dasarath, your sin is very great.
ती दुईजना दम्पतिमा श्रीमानले दशरथ राजालाई भन्नुभयो कि तपाईँले एउटा ठुलो पाप गर्नुभयो किनकि अब हाम्रो छोरा नभएको कारणले अब हामीहरू बाँच्नुको कुनै अर्थ छैन हामीहरू दुईजनै अब अग्निमा प्रवेश गर्छौँ र प्राण दाह गर्छौँ तपाईँले ठुलो पाप गर्नुभयो भनेर भन्दै गर्नुहुन्छ
That as I am dying without my son being present, I curse you in the same way that you will also die without your son by your side.
र त्यति नै बेला ती वृद्ध मानिसले भन्नुभयो कि जसरी मेरो छोराको अनुपस्थितिमा मेरो अहिले प्राण अन्त्य हुँदैछ त्यसै गरी तपाईँको पनि मृत्युको समयमा आफ्नो पुत्र नजिकमा नभइकन तपाईँको निधन होस् भनेर श्राप दिए
So in this way Maharaj Dasarath remembered that curse and he saw how now it was going to take place that his son had gone off to the forest and he was alone without his son and in this way Maharaj Dasarath gave up his life
र त्यति नै बेलामा यी कुराहरू दशरथ राजाले याद गर्दै र अब मेरो त्यही नै समय आइपुगेछ भन्ने कुरा उहाँलाई याद भयो र आफ्नो छोराको अनुपस्थितिमा दशरथ राजाले यसरी शोकमा आफ्नो प्राण त्याग गर्नु परेको थियो
सो महाराज एक्चुअली When Sita and Rama and Lakshman were going into the forest, all the citizens of Ayodhya, they loved Lord Rama so much, they said, we also want to go with you.
Jati bela Sita, Ram and Lakshman waharule raj darbar tyagera jangal janu pareko thiyo. Teti bela prajaharu pani waharulai eti maya garthe ki haina aba tapai bina hami kina basne, hami pani jangal le aauchhau bhanera.
But Lord Rama said, no, no, you cannot come with us. If you come with us, then the city will become the forest, and the forest will become like the city.
यदि तपाईहरु प्रजाहरु नै यसरी जंगलमा आउनु भयो भने जंगल चाहिँ राज्य हुन्छ अनि राज्य चाहिँ जंगल हुन्छ त्यो भएर तपाईहरु आउन मिल्दैन भनेर रोक्नु भयो
My father wanted me to go to the forest. My duty is to go to the forest. You should stay here in the capital, Ayodhya, and maintain the city.
Ra Bhagwan Ramchandra le bhannubhayo ki mero pitaji le malai jangal jana chahanu huncha tesele ma waha ko adesh ma jin jangal janchu tara tapai haru yahi Ayodhya nagari ma basnu hos ra yaha yo nagari ko khyal garnu hos bhanera bhannubhayo
So when Maharaj Dasarath died, they called Bharat to come. Bharat had gone to visit some other city far away. So they told him to come back. And when he came back, they told him, now you're going to become the king. Look, Ram, your brother has gone to the forest, so you will become the king. But Bharat said, no, I can never be the king. Ram is the king. Ram should be the king, not me.
दशरथ राजाको देहावसान भयो त्यस बेला भरत अन्तै कता अर्को सहरमा कतै जानुभएको थियो र भरतलाई बोलाइयो तिमी अब राजा बन्न आऊ भनेर भन्दा भरतले भन्थे होइन म राजा बन्ने होइन मेरो दाइ राम बन्नुपर्छ म बन्दिनँ भन्नुभएको थियो
So when Bharat heard the news, he went into the forest to find Ram. And when he found Lord Ram, he told him the news that our father has died. You should come home now and become the king. But Lord Rama refused. He said, no, my father told me to go to the forest for 14 years. I have to keep my promise to our father.
जानु भयो र रामचन्द्रलाई भन्नुभयो हाम्रो पिताजीले यो संसार छोड्नुभयो अब तपाईँ आएर राज्य चलाउनु पर्यो राजा बन्नु पर्यो भन्दाखेरि रामचन्द्रले भन्नुहुन्छ होइन मैले त पिताजीको आदेश मान्नुपर्छ म 14 वर्ष वनवासमा बस्नु भनेर आदेश छ म त बस्छु म अब जान्न भनेर भन्नुहुन्छ
सो Bharat took the koram, the wooden shoes of Lord Rama. And he took them back to the palace and he installed them on the throne as the king and he worshipped them every day.
Ra jati bela Bharat Maharaj le Ramchandra ka ti charan ka paduka thie tiner lai leera gaera raja ko basne gaddi ma rakhnu bhayo ra din kai waha le tesko puja garnuthyo.
And Bharat was also doing great austerities. Although he had the whole palace of Ayodhya to himself, he could enjoy as much as he wanted. Every day he would simply eat some rice cooked in the urine of a cow.
र जति बेला भरत महाराजले राज्यमा बसेर राज्यका सबै सुख सुविधाहरू भोग गर्न सक्नुहुन्थ्यो तर भरत महाराजले त्यसो नगरेर बडो तपस्या गर्नुभयो र हरेक दिन एक पटक मात्र थोरै अनुपातमा राइस लिनुहुन्थ्यो त्यसलाई पनि गाईको गहुँतमा पकाएर खाने गर्ने यस्तो गर्नुहुन्थ्यो
सो लॉर्ड राम ही हैड मेड हिज वाउ टु गो इन्टु द फॉरेस्ट एन्ड मदर सीता एन्ड लक्ष्मण अकम्पनीड हिम एन्ड टुगेदर दे लिव्ड देयर इन द फॉरेस्ट दे फाउन्ड नाइस प्लेसेस इन द फॉरेस्ट दे वुड ले ऑन बेड्स ऑफ लीव्स And they would decorate themselves with the forest flowers and they would simply eat whatever roots and fruits whichever they could find in the forest.
Ra esari Sita ani Ram jangal ma jab rahnu bhayeko thiyo tete bela waharlai bado ramro basne byawastha ke thiyo bhanna khari jangal ka pat patingar haru esma yo nai waharko shayan ke भेड भएको थियो भने उहाँहरूले जङ्गलका कन्दमूलहरू फलफुलहरू जराहरू यस्ता यस्ता पखाल्ने खाने जङ्गलको यो हिसाबले बस्नुहुन्थ्यो
सो एज वी सेड देयर वर मेनी राक्षसस इन द फॉरेस्ट एन्ड रावण आल्सो ह्याड हिज किंगडम एन्ड सम अफ हिज डिफरेंट सोल्जर्स वर आल्सो कमिंग थ्रु द फॉरेस्ट एन्ड समटाइम्स लॉर्ड रामचन्द्र और लक्ष्मण वुड हैव टु डील विथ देम दे'ड हैव टु किल देम
र त्यति बेला धेरै राक्षसहरू थिए र रावणका धेरै अरू सेनाहरू राक्षसहरू पनि त्यो जङ्गलको बाटो हिँड्ने डुल्ने आदि गर्ने गर्दथे र रामचन्द्र भगवान् र लक्ष्मणले उनीहरूलाई सामना गर्नुपर्थ्यो
रावण had assistants like Karn and Dushana and Kar They were his two main assistants and they came and they were both killed by Lord Ramachandra. And when Ravan heard this, he was very angry. And then his sister came, Surpanaka.
Ra jati bela Ravan ka thula sahayogi haru dui jana rakshasharu khar ani dushan naam gareka rakshasharu thie ti dui jane lai bhagwan Ramachandra le vadh garnu pareko thiyo tespachi अर्को रावणको त्यस कुराले रावणलाई धेरै रिस उठाएको थियो पछि रावणकी बहिनी सुपर्णका पनि त्यहाँ आइपुगेकी थिइन्
सो सुपर्णका केम टु द क्याम्प अफ लॉर्ड रामचन्द्र व्हेन शी सॉ लॉर्ड रामा देन शी बिकेम अट्र्याक्टेड टु हिम एन्ड शी डिजायर्ड टु हैव अ रिलेशनशिप विथ हिम एन्ड शी न्यू ही इज अ क्षत्रिय एन्ड क्षत्रियज आर ड्युटी बाउन्ड टु एक्सेप्ट एनी वुमन टु सटिस्फाई देम
र सुपर्णका जब रामचंद्र को जो कुटी में आईपुगे थीं भगवान रामचंद्र को बड़ो सुंदरता देखकर उनी आकर्षित भएकी थीं उनले रामचंद्रसंग सहवास करने इच्छा व्यक्त करीं उनलाई थाहा थियो कि क्षेत्रीय जोसुके महिलाले पनि स्वीकार गर भनेपछि उनीहरूले अस्वीकार गर्न हुँदैन त्यो भएर म यिनलाई यो भन्छु भन्ने हिसाबले अगाडि बढिन्
But as I was saying, Lord Ramachandra is Maryada avatar. He shows the perfect behavior and he had made the vow, Eka Patni Vrat. He was only going to take one wife and he already had married Mother Sita. He did not want to have any kind of relationship with Surpanika.
जबकि भगवान रामचन्द्र मर्यादा पुरुषोत्तमको अभिनयमा हुनुहुन्थ्यो त्यसैले मर्यादा पुरुषोत्तम रामचन्द्रले एक पत्नी व्रत हुनुभएको कारणले अर्को पत्नीसँग सम्बन्ध नराख्ने उहाँको वाचा भएको हुनाले उहाँ आफ्नो वाचामा पनि अडिग हुनुहुन्थ्यो
Surpanika was the sister of Ram. She was a rakshasi. She had evil powers. And she tried to, when she saw Lord Rama was not interested in her, Lord Ram said, why don't you have my younger brother? He's not married yet. You know? But Lakshman said, no, I'm just a young brother. You should have my older brother. And in this way, Surpanika was becoming angry and she attacked Mother Sita.
Surpanika, Ravan ki bahini thin, ti rakshasi pani thin. र उनीलाई एक किसिमको राक्षसी विद्याहरू आदि राम्रो जान्दथिन् र जति बेला भगवान् रामचन्द्रले उहाँलाई अस्वीकार गर्नुभयो र किनकि म विवाहित भइसकेँ म तिमीलाई स्वीकार गर्न सक्दिनँ भन्नुभएको थियो र उहाँले मेरो भाइ बहिनी लक्ष्मण छन् लक्ष्मणले बिहा गरेका छैनन् तिमी उनीतर्फ जाऊ मलाई यता नआऊ भनेपछि उनले लक्ष्मणपट्टि गइन् अनि लक्ष्मणले भन्नुभयो होइन म त सेवक हुँ भगवान्को मैले यो गर्न स्वीकार गर्न हुँदैन भनेपछि उनलाई त्यस पछाडि कसैले नै स्वीकार नगरेपछि धेरै रिस उठेर सीता महारानीलाई उनले आक्रमण गर्न तम्सिन्
She became very envious of Sita because she saw Sita so beautiful, such a beautiful woman. So she was a rakshasi, an ugly rakshasi. And here she was trying to have a relate. So she was being refused by this Ravan, by Ram and Lakshman. So she attacked Sita. So Lord Rama immediately took out his sword and he cut off Surpanika's nose and sent her running, crying to her big brother, Ravan.
जबकि सीता महारानी अत्यन्त सुन्दर हुनुहुन्थ्यो र सुपर्णखाले आफू अस्वीकृत भएको देख्ने बित्तिकै सीता महारानीप्रति बडो ईर्ष्यालको भावनाले उनले सीता महारानीलाई आक्रमण गर्ने विचार गरिन् र त्यो देखेर जब सीता महारानीले आक्रमण गर्न लागेको देखेपछि उहाँको तरबार निकालेर रामचन्द्र भगवान्ले पनि पहिला आदेश दिएर उहाँको नाक काट्ने काम भएको थियो
So Mother Sita wanted, Surpanika told her brother about the beauty of this woman Sita because she knew her brother is very attracted to beautiful women. And she told her brother that this Sita is the most beautiful of all women, that you will be very attracted to her. So Ravan was very interested, a beautiful woman. Another beautiful woman is very eager to get her.
र यसरी गएकी सुपर्णखाले आफ्नो भाइ दाई रावणलाई भन्न थालिन् कि ओहो त्यहाँ सीता छन् अति सुन्दर महिला छन् भनेर सीता महारानीको सुन्दरताको बारेमा खुब व्याख्या गर्न लागिन् र किनकि उनलाई थाहा थियो कि मेरो भाइ सुन्दरी स्त्रीहरूप्रति बडो इच्छुक छ त्यो भएर अर्को सुन्दरी स्त्रीको बारेमा अनि अर्को सुन्दरी स्त्रीको बारेमा उसलाई धेरै चाह हुन्छ भनेर उनले आफ्नो भाइलाई सीता महारानी भयो भने यस्तै सुन्दरी युवती भयो भने तिमीलाई धेरै राम्रो हुन्छ आदि इत्यादि भनेर रावणलाई पुरा व्याख्या गर्न लागिन्
However, Surpanika told her brother that this Ram is no ordinary person, that he is very powerful. And he's already killed two of your great generals, Kar and Dushan. So you will have to be very careful how you deal with him.
Surpanika le Ravan lai sachet puraun le bhanin ki जेनै भए पनि तिमीले बडो सावधानीपूर्वक यो काम गर्नुपर्छ, किनभने रामचन्द्र पनि धेरै शक्तिशाली हुनुहुन्छ। तिम्रा महान शक्तिशाली जेनरलहरू दुईजना खर र दूषणलाई पहिला नै रामचन्द्रले वध गरिसक्नु भएको छ। यो कामलाई बडो सावधानी भएर गर्नु भनेर उनलाई सम्झाइ बुझाइ गर्छिन्।
So Ravan took the help of a person called Marichi, and he told Marichi, I want you to help me because I'm going to kidnap the wife of Ram. I want to kidnap his wife Sita, and I need you to help me.
र जति बेला रावणले एकजना मरिचीको सहायता मागे र भने, मलाई म अब सीतालाई अपहरण गर्न चाहन्छु, म त्यसको लागि जाँदा मलाई तिमीले यसमा यो काममा सहायता गर भनेर भन्छन्।
So Marichi thought about it and he thought, if I do this for Ravan, then certainly Lord Rama will kill me. But if I don't do it, then certainly Ravana will kill me. It's better I be killed by Lord Rama rather than by Ravana. So I better do what Ravana says.
र जति बेला मरिचीले धेरै विचार गरे अनि भने विचारपूर्वक सोचे कि यदि म रावणको यो कुरा माने भने रामचन्द्रको हातबाट मेरो मृत्यु हुन्छ, र यदि रावणले भने यो कुरा मानिनँ भने मलाई रावणले मारि नै हाल्छन्, बरु रावणको हातबाट मर्नु भन्दा त रामचन्द्रको हातबाट मर्नु नै बेस भन्ने उनले सोचे।
So Marichi, he took the form of a golden deer and he went off to the camp where Lord Rama was residing, and Mother Sita, being a woman, she was attracted by the golden deer. She thought, oh, look at that beautiful animal. Why don't get it for me? Bring it here. And she requested her husband, Lord Ram, please go and get that deer for me. Oh, it looks so nice. Of course, Lord Rama knew that this is no ordinary deer. This is some trick. But in order to please his wife, he went after the deer.
जति बेला मरिची यो योजना अनुसार सुनको शरीर लिएर सीता महारानी भएको छेउछाउमा रामचन्द्रको कुटीको वरिपरि गएका थिए, र सीता महारानी एकजना महिला सुलभ स्वभाव देखाउँदै उहाँले भन्नुभयो, ओहो हेर्नुहोस् रामचन्द्र, मलाई कति मन पर्यो त्यो सुनको मृग, यसलाई ल्याइदिनुहोस् भनेर उहाँले अनुरोध गर्नुभयो। अनि रामचन्द्र भगवान्ले पनि यो कुरा थाहा पाइहाल्नुभयो कि यो मृग त साधारण मृग होइन, सुनको मृग हुन सक्दैन, यहाँ केही जालझेल पक्कै छ भन्ने कुरा उहाँले विचार गर्नुभयो।
So Mother Sita was left in the care of Lakshman. She was always either with Lord Rama or with Lakshman. Lord Rama had gone after the deer, and Lakshman was there guarding Sita. And at that time, Marichi very cleverly cried out, as if he was Lord Rama, he cried out, Lakshman, Sita, help me.
र त्यति बेला रामचन्द्र भगवान्ले जब मरिचीलाई यसरी पिछा गर्दै जानुभएको थियो, र त्यस बेला मरिचले पनि अलि टाढा पुगेपछि आफ्नो बडो चातुर्यपूर्वक भने कि ए लक्ष्मण, सीता, मलाई रामचन्द्रको आवाज निकाल्दै मलाई सहयोग गर्नुहोस्, मलाई सहयोग चाहियो भनेर मरिचीले यो गर्छन्।
So Lakshman was not tricked, but Mother Sita thought, oh, my husband's in danger. Lakshman, you should go immediately. Go and see what's wrong. Go and see. Lakshman said, nothing can happen to your husband. He is Lord Rama. Nothing can harm him. Don't be fooled. This is some trick. But Sita said, oh, you should go. You should go. You are just trying to enjoy me. You just want me instead of my husband.
लक्ष्मण सीताको संरक्षणमा बस्नुभएको थियो, र सीता महारानीले लक्ष्मणलाई आदेश दिँदै भन्नुभयो, लक्ष्मण तिमी जाऊ, रामचन्द्रलाई अप्ठ्यारो पऱ्यो, तुरुन्त जाऊ भन्दाखेरि, अनि लक्ष्मणले भन्नुहुन्छ, माता सीता, यो रामचन्द्रको आवाज होइन, रामचन्द्रलाई यस्तो केही पनि हुन सक्दैन, तपाईँ यसमा भ्रममा नपर्नुहोस् भन्दाखेरि सीता महारानीलाई पनि उहाँले लक्ष्मणलाई अझ जोडले भन्नुहुन्छ कि लक्ष्मण तिमी तुरुन्त जाऊ, रामचन्द्रलाई सहयोग गर, किनभने तिमीले किन नगएको भनेर तिमीलाई के रामचन्द्र चाहन्छ कि तिमीले मलाई चाहेको कि के हो यस्तो भनेर लक्ष्मणलाई थर्काउँदै भन्नुहुन्छ.
So Lakshman was very hurt by the harsh words of Mother Sita. Actually, Lakshman never even saw the face of Sita. He only saw her feet. He never had even looked on her face.
Ra Sita Maharani ka esta tikha vachan le Lakshman lai ekdam bhitra hriday ma chuncha jabaki Lakshman ले सीता महारानीलाई माताको भावमा हेर्नुहुन्थ्यो र कहिल्यै पनि चरण कमलबाट माथि हेर्नु भएन. सीता महारानीको मुख त कहिल्यै पनि हेर्नु भएको थिएन.
He was thinking, Sita is the wife of my brother. I have no right to enjoy her beauty. He would not look on her face. So but Mother Sita was speaking so harshly, he thought, I have to go. But before he went, he said, I'm putting a mantra, a shield, a kavacha around you to protect you. And if you stay within this circle, then nobody can harm you. Promise me you will stay within this circle.
जबकि लक्ष्मणले जहिले पनि सीता महारानी मेरो दाजु रामको श्रीमती हुनुहुन्छ र उहाँलाई मैले कहिल्यै पनि आनन्द लिने भावनाले हेर्न हुँदैन भनेर त्यो उहाँको मनमा राम्रो भावना थियो भने जबकि सीता महारानीले लक्ष्मणलाई कर गरेर तिखा तिखा वचनले उहाँलाई गाली गर्न थालेपछि लक्ष्मणले जान विवश हुनुभयो र सीता महारानीलाई उहाँले वचन दिँदै भन्नुभयो कि ठिकै छ तर तपाईँले पनि मलाई भन्नुहोस् कि म यहाँ तपाईँलाई एउटा कवच बनाएर जान्छु यो कवचबाट तपाईँले यो घेरा ननाग्नुहोस् र यो घेराभित्र बस्नुभयो भने तपाईँलाई कसैले केहीले पनि केही बाधा पुर्याउन सक्दैन भनेर भन्नुभयो.
This is very relevant to devotees because we also have a kavacha which protects us. Our kavacha are the four regulative principles. If we strictly follow the four principles and chant every day the Maha Mantra 16 rounds, then Maya cannot touch us. We will be protected from all dangers.
अनि यो कुरा हामी भक्तहरूसँग पनि हाम्रो जीवनमा सम्बन्धित छ कि हामी भक्तहरूले पनि हाम्रो कवच सधैँ धारण गर्नुपर्ने कवच चार नियमहरू हुन्. यसलाई बडो सावधानीपूर्वक पालना गऱ्यौँ भने हामी सुरक्षित हुन्छौँ र चार नियम अनि सोह्र माला जप गरेपछि हामीलाई मायाले आक्रमण गर्न सक्दैन.
But as soon as we deviate, a little off track, a little inattention, we don't follow strictly, then we're open for trouble, and trouble comes in the form of maya.
Ra jabaki hamiharu yo niyam bada alikati pani path bhramit bhayau bhane hamiharu lai yo kura lai ramro sang palana nagareko khanda ma maya le hamiharu lai akraman garcha bibhinna dukha haru vyavadhan haru kashta haru aiparna thaldachan.
So seeing that Mother Sita had been left alone in the forest, Ravan came disguised as a sadhu and begging alms. He came begging some foodstuffs from Mother Sita.
Ra jabaki esari Lakshman pani tada hunu bhaisakeko avastha ma Ravan ek jana chadma bheshi sadhu bhanera aipugchan ra Sita maharani lai bhiksha mageko bahana gardachan.
When he tried to approach her, because the kavacha was protecting her, he would be burned. He could not enter near to her.
Ra esari aunda kheri Ravan le to kavach le suraksha garieko ghera bhitra pravesh garna sakdainan kinaki tya bhitra pravesh garna lagda Ravan lai jalaune ra Ravan kharani huna sakne testo avastha thiyo ra Sita maharani lai chhuna nasakne hunale Ravan pani darasnan kheti.
So he had to tempt her, please come to me, I'm old man, I cannot walk, you kindly bring your fruit to me. And Mother Sita came out of the shield which was protecting her. And as soon as she came out of the shield, then immediately Ravan grabbed her and he revealed him his real identity and he had an aeroplane and he brought Mother Sita and they went on the aeroplane and flew off to Lanka.
र जबकि रावणले यसरी बहानापूर्वक अब म तपाईँको यो घेराभित्र आउन सक्दिनँ, म बुढो मान्छे धेरै हिँड्न सक्दिनँ भनेर यस्तो बहाना बनाउन लागेर सीता महारानीलाई घेराबाट बाहिर आउनलाई अनुरोध गरेर घेरा बाहिर आएर भिक्षा दिन भनेपछि सीता महारानीले घेरा बाहिर आएर जब भिक्षा दिन थाल्नुहुन्छ त्यति बेला रावणले सीता महारानीलाई पक्रिने हुन्छ र पक्रिएपछि आफ्नो वास्तविक स्वभाव म रावण हुँ भन्ने प्रकट गरेर उनको एयरप्लेनमा सीता महारानीलाई लिएर लङ्का जाने तयारी गर्छन्।
So, while Ravan was flying to Lanka, he was seen by Jatayu. Jatayu is a great bird who is also a great devotee of Lord Rama. And he saw Mother Sita being kidnapped by Ravan. So Jatayu came to fight with Ravan. But Ravan was more powerful and he cut the wings of Jatayu. And Jatayu crashed to the ground and died.
यसरी सीता महारानीलाई रावणले विमानमा राखेर लिएर जाँदै गरेको जटायुले देखे र जटायु पनि एकजना महान चरा भए पनि ठुलै चरा थिए, भगवान्का भक्त थिए र जटायुले सीता महारानीको संरक्षणलाई गर्नलाई रावणलाई आक्रमण गर्छन् ताकि रावण जटायुभन्दा पनि बलवान भएको हुनाले जटायुको रावणले दुइटै पखेटा काट्दिन्छन् र जटायु भुइँमा गिर्छन् र मृत्युको प्रतीक्षामा जटायु हुन्छन्।
So Jatayu was killed, but it was a glorious death. Before his departure, Lord Rama came just as he was leaving the body. Lord Rama came there and was able to spend the last moments of the life of Jatayu with him, consoling him. And Jatayu told Lord Rama how Mother Sita had been kidnapped. At that time, Jatayu gave up his life in the arms of Lord Ramachandra. He also got perfection in his life.
जबकि जटायुको मृत्यु पनि बडो गौरवशाली मृत्यु थियो, महान मृत्यु भयो, किनभने जटायु मर्नु अगाडि रामचन्द्र भगवान् आउनुभएको थियो र जटायुले रामचन्द्रलाई कसरी सीतालाई रावणले अपहरण गरेर लाँदै गरेको कुरा आदि सबै बताउनुभयो र अनि रामचन्द्रको काखमा जटायुले आफ्नो प्राण त्याग गरे र आफ्नो जीवन बडो राम्रोसँग अन्त्य भयो जटायुको।
Although Jatayu had not been successful in saving Sita from the hands of Ravan, he was successful, his life was successful because he had sacrificed his life for the service of the Lord.
र जबकि जटायुले सीता महारानीको पूर्ण सुरक्षा गर्न नसके तापनि जटायुले भगवानको सेवामा सीता महारानीको संरक्षणको लागि आफ्नो प्राण त्याग गर्नु परेको थियो र यो बडो महान मृत्यु थियो र उनको जीवन धन्य भयो यसले।
So then Lord Ramachandra and Lakshman find out Mother Sita has gone. They come back to the camp and she's not there. And they wonder, what has happened? Where can she be? Where is she gone? But then they met Jatayu and Jatayu told them what had happened. So they want to know, where is she gone? Where did this demon take Mother Sita?
Ra, esari jabaki harinko baad pachi Ramchandra Bhagwan ra Lakshman jab aafno ashram kuti ma auna huncha teti bela Sita Maharani nabhayeko yo avastha bhaye pachi अनि कता हुनुहुन्छ के हुनुहुन्छ भन्ने खोजीमा जाँदै गर्दाखेरि जटायुसँग भेट हुन्छ अनि जब जटायुसँग भेट हुन्छ अनि सीता महारानीको यसरी अपहरण भएको आदि सबै कुरा जटायुले सबै रामचन्द्रलाई बताउँदछन्।
So at that time Lord Rama was able to meet with Sugriva and he heard about Sugriva's problem that he'd been thrown out by his brother Bali and Bali had taken Sugriva's wife and Sugriva was living without any kingdom.
Ra teti bela Ramchandra Bhagwan ko case pachi Sugriv sanga mitrata huncha, wahar sanga bhetghat huncha. Ra ani Sugriv ko pani euta samasya ke huncha bhane Bali Sugriv ka dajule Bali ko patni pani aparan gareka hunchan. To matra haina Bali lai rajya bata bahiskar garieko huncha.
So Sugriva said, I'm willing to help you find your wife, but you must help me first get back my wife and get the kingdom. Then my army can all come and we'll all help you to look for Sita. So Lord Rama told Sugriva, all right, you go and arrange another fight with your brother. But Vali was much stronger than Sugriva, and Sugriva was being defeated. However, Lord Rama was watching, and he took advantage that he fired an arrow into the chest of Vali and killed him.
जेने भए पनि म तपाईको पत्नीको खोजीमा यी कार्यमा सबैमा सहायता गर्छु तर तपाईको सहायता गर्नु भन्दा पहिला मलाई नै सहायताको जरुरी छ किनभने पहिला त मेरो पत्नी राज्य आदि सबै पाउनु पर्यो र जबकि मैले आफ्नो राज्य पाउँछु त्यसपछि मेरा सैनिकहरु सबैको सहायताले म तपाईलाई पूरै सहयोग गर्न सक्छु भनेर बालीले भन्नुभयो अनि रामचन्द्रले ठीक सुग्रीवलाई राज्य पाएपछि पाउने कुरा आदि भएपछि रामचन्द्रले सुग्रीवलाई ठिकै छ ल अब तिमी ठिकै छ गएर बालीसँग युद्ध गर भनेर युद्ध गर्ने कुरा व्यवस्था भयो र रामचन्द्रको बाणले बालीको निधन भएको थियो
So when Vali fell pierced by the arrow of Lord Ramachandra, he voiced his complaint. He said to Lord Ram, "This is not fair. You have not acted according to the Kshatriya codes. You hid behind a tree and fired an arrow against me. It was not fair. Why you killed me in this way?" And Lord Rama told Bali that you were not fair. You did so many irreligious things. You were unfair to your brother Sugriva. You took his wife. You kicked him out of the kingdom. You did not give him a fair chance. Why I should be fair to you?
बालीलाई भगवान रामचन्द्रको बाणले लागेको थियो र बाली मृत्युको मुखमा पुग्दै थिए र बालीले रामचन्द्रलाई देखेर भन्छन् कि तपाईँले यो कस्तो बडो अन्याय गर्नुभयो यो क्षेत्रीयहरूको तरिका कहाँ हो यस्तो लुकेर चाहिँ मलाई पछाडिबाट बाण हानेर यसरी वध गर्न कहाँ पाइन्छ यो त यो न्यायसङ्गत भएन भनेर रामचन्द्रलाई बालीले भन्छन् अनि भगवान रामचन्द्रले भन्नुहुन्छ कि वास्तवमै तिमीले पहिला नै यस्ता धेरै नियमहरू तोडिसकेका छौ आफ्नो भाइको पत्नी अपहरण गर्ने भाइलाई राज्यबाट निष्कासन गर्ने र धेरै यस्ता यस्ता अन्यायहरू गरेको मान्छे तिमीलाई अब कहाँको न्यायको कुरा गर्छ भनेर रामचन्द्रले भन्नुहुन्छ
एन्ड एनीवे यु आर एन एनिमल सो किलिङ एनिमल देयर इज नो rules there, that you behave like an animal, you are an animal, so I have killed you as I'm a Kshatriya.
Ra, timi jeni bhaye pani euta pasavik vyavahar, pasu ko jasto vyavahar garireheka hunale, euta pasu lai yesari marna ko lagi khasai testo kehi niyam chahidaina, ra maile timro badh gare bhannuhuncha.
So in this way the armies of Sugriva were united to help Lord Rama look for Mother Sita. And among the army of Sugriva, of course, was the great devotee Hanuman, who was always very, very respectful and very eager to serve Lord Ramachandra.
Ra, esari jaba Sugriva ka sainikharu sabai ko sahayata le Sita Maharani ko khoji karya huna lagyo. Ra, ti sainikharu ma ekjana mahan Bhagwan ka bhakta Hanuman pani thiye. Ra, esari Sita Maharani ko khoji karya agadi badhyo.
So they had. That in course of time they heard that Mother Sita had been taken to Ravana's kingdom, Lanka, which was across the ocean. So they thought, how to go there? And the different monkeys were asked, could you be able to jump? And the only monkey who could jump that far was Hanuman.
जब उनीहरूले सीता महारानीलाई समुद्र पारी लंकामा पुर्याइएको थाहा पाए त्यस पछाडि सबै बानर सेनाहरूले भन्न थाले र कुन चाहिँ बाँदरले यहाँबाट हाम फालेर त्यहाँ पुग्ने तिमी उफ्रेर पारि पुग्न सक्छौ भनेर एकले अर्कालाई सोध्थे र त्यति टाढासम्म जम्प गरेर जान सक्ने हनुमान मात्र हुनुहुन्थ्यो
Hanuman, even when he was jumping across the ocean, there were so many Rakshasas who tried to stop him, who tried to devour him as he was leaping across through the air. But Hanuman defeated all of them and he got to Lanka.
Ra esari Hanuman, samundra paar garne kramma, dherai rakshasarle unlai vyavadhan purauna thaleka thiye, ra Hanuman le ti sabailai haraudai Lanka pugnu bhayeko thiyo.
Then he found out Mother Sita, where she was, that she was in the Ashok Van, And Mother Sita met with Hanuman and she gave her ring to Hanuman to show to Lord Ramachandra.
Aisari Hanuman jab Lanka ma pugnu bhayo, Lanka puge pachi Sita Maharani lai Ashok Vatika ma dekhnu bhayo, ra Sita Maharani sanga Hanuman ko bhetghat huncha ani Sita Maharani sanga aunthi dine I kaam haru huncha.
But then Hanuman, he wanted to give some trouble to Ravan. So after meeting with Mother Sita, then he began to destroy parts of the kingdom of Ravan. And at one point, Hanuman allowed himself to be arrested. And Ravana set fire to the tail of Hanuman.
रावण को बगैचा हरू यता उता सबै तहस नहस पार्न थाल्छन् र त्यसपछि एक एक छेउमा पुगेर हनुमानले आफैलाई समात्नलाई अनुमति दिन्छन् र हनुमानको पुछारमा पक्रेर आगो लगाउने काम हुन्छ
Hanuman with his tail blazing, he again set about destroying the kingdom of Lanka, setting fire to buildings one after another. And then he jumped back to rejoin Lord Ramachandra and tell Lord Ramachandra the news that he had found Mother Sita.
Ra esari Hanuman le jab pucharma aago laeko bhaye pachi ek pachi arko ghar gardai Lanka sabai Hanuman le jalai dinu bhayo ra esari Lanka jalai pachi Hanuman ani Ramchandra ko ma farkera janu bhayo ra Sita Maharani lai bhetnu bhayeko ra adi sabai vritantaharu bhannu bhayo.
And when Lord Ramachandra got the news, he looked across the ocean and he was so angry that from his glance all the ocean began to heat and all the different aquatics, the different fish and creatures living in the sea, they were all being burned by the heat of the glance of Lord Ramachandra.
जब रामचन्द्र ले यी सबै कुराहरू थाहा भएपछि उहाँले बडो क्रोधमा आउनुभयो र रामचन्द्र रिसाएर समुद्रमा हेर्नु भएको थियो त्यति बेला उहाँको आँखाबाट निस्केको तापले पानी नै तातेर त्यहाँका पानीमा माछाहरू अरू जल जन्तुहरू पनि पानीको तापले पीडित भएका थिए
The god of the ocean then appeared and offered respects to Lord Ramachandra and begged Lord Ramachandra that you please, please don't do this. Please construct a bridge across the water so that you can go to Lanka. Please don't burn up all the living entities in the sea.
Ra espachi samundra ko adhishtata devata prakat hunubhayo ra उहाँले भगवान् रामचन्द्रलाई अनुरोध गर्दै भन्नुभयो कृपया यसरी यो नगर्नुहोस् यो सबै प्राणीहरू सबैलाई सबै विनाश हुन्छन् बरु तपाईँले समुद्रमाथि पुल बनाउनुहोस् पुल पार गरेर तपाईँ लङ्का जान सक्नुहुन्छ भनेर उहाँलाई यो सबै कुरा भन्नुभयो
सो एभ्रीवन वाज रिक्रुटेड टु हेल्प बिल्ड द ब्रिज अक्रॉस द सी टु लङ्का All the different bears and monkeys and Hanuman and everyone, they were all helping, bringing rocks and trees, building this bridge across the sea.
Ra jaba samundra mathi pul banaune kaam ma sabai jangal ka bhalu haru ani vishesh garera banar haru le yesari sabai le ek saath lagera pul banaune kaam ma agadi lage ra aba pul par garera lanka jane taiyari ma sabai juti raheka thie
at one point Hanuman was you know working so hard bringing big rocks and throwing them a little spider was in the way was bringing some dust but Hanuman told the spider get out of my way let me do it but Lord Ramachandra told Hanuman no this spider he is also my devotee he is also serving me don't stop him from doing his service
ra jati bela hanuman le thula thula pathar haru pahad haru yesari uchalera samundra ma phalne kram ma euta sano kira makura estale pani pul banauna lai sahayak garirheka thie ra hanuman le मेरो बाटोमा आएर यो स्पाइडरले बाटो डिस्टर्ब गर्यो भनेर मेरो बाटोबाट भाग भनेर चाहिँ यसरी भन्दाखेरि अनि रामचन्द्र भगवान्ले भन्नुभयो कि होइन यो पनि मेरो भक्त हो यसको सानो सेवा पनि मेरो सेवा नै हो भनेर हनुमानलाई सम्झाउनु भयो.
So in this way the bridge was built. But before Lord Ramachandra crossed to Lanka, he first of all did some puja. He worshipped Lord Shiva.
यसरी समुद्रमाथि पुल बनाउने काम भएको थियो र रामचन्द्रले समुद्रमाथि चढेर लङ्का जानु अगाडि भगवान् शिवजीको पूजा गर्नुभएको थियो.
So people were puzzled by this. You know, why is Lord Ramachandra, he's supposed to be Bhagwan, he's the personality of Godhead, why is he worshipping Lord Shiva?
र मानिसहरूले भन्ने गर्छन् कि भगवान् रामचन्द्र आफै भगवान् हुनुहुन्छ उहाँले किन शिवजीको यसरी पूजा आराधना गर्नु पर्यो भनेर मानिसहरूले सोध्ने गर्दछन्.
Srila Prabhupada explained this. He said that, well, he said Lord Ramachandra was simply telling Lord Shiva, I'm going to kill your devotee.
र यो कुरामा प्रभुपादले भन्नुहुन्छ कि शिवजीलाई भगवान् रामचन्द्रले म तपाईँको एउटा भक्तलाई वध गर्न जाँदैछु भनेर भन्नुभएको हो भनेर भन्नुहुन्छ.
Ravan was a great devotee of Lord Shiva. He got a lot of his powers, his benedictions from Lord Shiva. So Lord Rama was telling Shiva, I'm going to kill him.
र रावण शिवजीको एउटा ठुलो भक्त भएको हुनाले शिवजीबाट रावणले धेरै आशीर्वादहरू पाइसकेका थिए र त्यो भएर रामचन्द्रले शिवजीको भक्तको वध गर्न जानु अगाडि शिवजीलाई म तिम्रो भक्तको विनाश गर्दैछु भनेर भन्नुभएको थियो.
Another reason why Lord Rama also did this puja was he's setting an example for common men. He wants ordinary people that they should also worship. Whatever you do, you have to worship, you have to do puja, you should respect the Lord. It is a Vedic culture.
र यो अर्को कुरा यसमा रामचन्द्र भगवान्ले एउटा उदाहरण पनि प्रस्तुत गर्नुभएको हो सबै मानिसहरूको लागि कि हामीहरूले जे गर्छौँ त्यो गर्नुभन्दा अगाडि हामीहरूले पूजा गर्नुपर्दछ भनेर यो पनि सिकाउनु भएको हो.
सो फर अर्डिनरी पिपल कमन दे वर्शिप लर्ड शिवा. Lord Rama, if Lord Ramachandra was to worship himself, it would not be very good. People would think, oh, I should also worship myself.
र यसरी भगवान् रामचन्द्रले उदाहरण प्रस्तुत गर्नुभयो कि साधारण मानिसहरूले यसरी शिवजीको पूजा गरेको देखेपछि ए भगवान् रामचन्द्रले पनि यसरी पूजा गर्नुभयो भने हामीले पनि गर्नुपर्छ भनेर एउटा देखाउनु भएको थियो.
So in this way, Lord Rama was able to cross over to Lanka with his army, and the great battle of Lanka commenced. Prabhupada said in the history of the world, there were two great battles, the battle of Lanka and the Kurukshetra battle. He said in both battles, the heroes were Vaishnavas. The hero at Kurukshetra was Arjuna, and the hero in the battle of Lanka was Hanuman.
र यसरी समुद्र पार गरेर लङ्कामा ठुलो युद्ध गरियो र अनि श्रील प्रभुपादले भन्नुहुन्छ कि पुरै इतिहासमा दुईवटा महान युद्धहरू भएका छन् ती ठुला ठुला युद्धहरूमा त्यसको हिरो त्यसको श्रेय भनेको वैष्णवहरूले पाएका छन् र त्यसको मुख्य जस्तो एउटा महाभारतको युद्ध त्यसका हिरो अर्जुन हुनुहुन्थ्यो भने अर्को लङ्काको रावणसँगको युद्ध त्यसमा त्यसको हिरो हनुमान हुनुहुन्थ्यो.
Lord Ramachandra also had been greatly helped by Vibhishan, who was one of the brothers of Ravan, and he had left this at the side of Ravan to come and help Lord Ramachandra.
र भगवान् रामचन्द्रलाई रावणका भाइ विभीषणले पनि ठुलो सहायता गरेका थिए र उनी रामचन्द्रको पक्षमा आएर भगवान्लाई सहयोग गरेका थिए.
So Ravan's army was very powerful and they were equipped with all kinds of modern warfare, deadly weapons. And Lord Rama's army were simply monkeys and bears, and their weapons were just trees and rocks. But it was Lord Rama's army which were victorious, and Ravan was killed.
जबकि रावण का सेनाहरू अत्याधुनिक हात हतियारहरूले सुसज्जित थिए उनीहरूलाई हात हतियारको केही कमी थिएन तर रामचन्द्र भगवानका सेनाहरू भने केवल बाँदरहरू जङ्गलका भालुहरू यिनीहरू थिए उनीहरूको हात हतियार भनेका ढुङ्गा मुढाहरू नै हुन्थे तैपनि आखिरमा रामचन्द्र भगवानको विजय भयो र रावणका सैनिकहरूको हार भएको थियो
And with the death of Ravan, then the kingdom of Lanka was given to Vibhishan to rule, the brother of Ravan, who had come to Lord Rama. He was made the king. And he was also told to worship Lord Jagannath.
And jabaki Ravan ko, jab Ravan ko mrityu bhai sakeko thiyo, त्यसपछि लङ्काको राज्य रावणका भाइ विभीषणलाई प्रदान गर्नुभयो भगवान् रामचन्द्रले र विभीषणलाई जगन्नाथ भगवानको पूजा गर्नको लागि भन्नुभएको थियो
There's one ring, a great big ring. It said it was the ring of Vibhishan. When Vibhishan came to worship Lord Jagannath. Some people, he was sometimes seen there coming to worship Lord Jagannath.
र एउटा ठुलो एउटा रिङ भनेको औँठी थियो त्यो चाहिँ विभीषणको थियो रे जो मानिसहरूले विभीषण त्यहाँ आउने गरेको पूजा गर्ने गरेको आदि कुराहरू बताउने गर्दछन्
सो देन लर्ड रामचन्द्र फाउन्ड मदर सीता एन्ड इमिडिएटली हि वान्टेड टु टेस्ट हर चास्टिटी एन्ड हि बिल्ट अ बिग फायर एन्ड अर्डर्ड हर टु एन्टर द फायर
र जब रामचन्द्र भगवानले सीता महारानीलाई भेट्नुभएको थियो त्यसपछि रामचन्द्रले उहाँलाई अग्नि परीक्षण गर्नुभयो र ठुलो आगो बालियो र सीता महारानीको पतिव्रताको व्रतको बारेमा परीक्षण गर्नलाई अग्निमा प्रवेश गर्न भनिएको थियो
So Vedic culture was like that. If the woman was touched by another man, then the husband would reject her.
र वैदिक संस्कृति यस्तै थियो कि यदि महिलाले अर्को मानिसलाई धारण गर्छिन् भने श्रीमानले ती महिलालाई त्याग्ने गर्दथे
सो मदर सीता शी बीइङ टेकन बाइ रावण सो लर्ड रामा वान्टेड टु प्रूव हर चास्टिटी हि बिल्ट दिस बिग फायर एन्ड मदर सीता एन्टर्ड इन्टु दैट फायर एन्ड फ्रम आउट अफ द फायर अग्नि द गॉड अफ फायर केम आउट क्यारिङ मदर सीता
र यसरी भगवान् रामचन्द्रले सीता महारानीलाई अग्निमा प्रवेश गर्न भन्नुभएपछि सीता महारानी अग्निमा जानुभयो र अग्निमा जानुभएपछि अग्नि भगवान् स्वयं सीता महारानीलाई बोकेर अग्निबाट बाहिर आउनुभएको थियो
The Sita who perished in the fire was actually the Maya Sita. The true Sita could never be touched by a demon like Ravana. Ravan simply took a Maya Sita, an illusory form of Mother Sita. He took that Sita with him to his kingdom Lanka. And that it was that Sita who perished in the fire. And the real Mother Sita came out of the fire.
Ra vastavmai Sita Maharani Agni le lyaunu bhayeko thiyo ra ek jana Sita jo Agni ma pravesh garnu bhayeko thiyo जसलाई रावणले अपहरण गरेको थियो ती सीता भनेको सीता महारानीको एउटा माया सीता सीता महारानीको झुक्याउने मात्र स्वरूप थियो जसलाई रावणले अपहरण गरेको थियो वास्तविक सीतालाई त रावणले छुन पनि सकेको थिएन
So then, Lord Ramachandra, Sita and Lakshman, they made the Pushpa Viman, flew aeroplane, and they flew back to Ayodhya. And they came back to Ayodhya on Diwali day and all the people had put lamps all around their house welcoming Lord Ram back to Ayodhya.
Ra esari espachi Sita Maharani lai liera Ramchandra Bhagwan ra Lakshman Pushpa ko biman banaera Ayodhya ma aunu bhayeko thiyo ra waharuko swagat ko lagi Diwali garieko thiyo ra पुरै अयोध्याभरि झिलिमिली बत्तीहरू बालेर रामचन्द्रलाई स्वागत गरिएको थियो
So Lord Ramachandra was very shocked to see that Bharat was doing such great austerity, only eating some grains of rice cooked in cow urine and that Lord Rama's wooden shoes were on the throne and being worshipped as the king every day. It was very painful to Lord Rama to see all of this.
भगवान रामचंद्र भरत महाराज को जुन कठोर तपस्या देखेर आफै चकित हुनुभएको थियो किनकि भरतले वास्तवमै केही सीमित अन्न चामललाई गाईको गहुँतमा पकाएर खाने अनि यसरी तपस्या गरेर बस्नु भएको थियो.
So then Lord Rama is back to Ayodhya. He becomes the king, and with Mother Sita and Bharat and Lakshman, Shatrughna, they were living there happily. But still Lord Ramachandra is concerned to know what do people think about him.
यसरी जब रामचन्द्र भगवान आएर अयोध्या आउनुभएपछि फेरि राजा बन्नुभयो र भरत लक्ष्मण शत्रुघ्न आदि सबै भाइहरूले उहाँलाई एकदम खुसीका साथ सधैँ रहनुभएको थियो र तैपनि रामचन्द्र भगवानले मानिसहरूले मेरो बारेमा के सोच्छन् कतिको के छन् भनेर जानकारी लिन चाहनुहुन्थ्यो.
His doors of his palace were always open. If anybody had any complaint, they were allowed to come and make their complaint. But nobody ever came and complained. So Lord Ramachandra would go and listen to hear what they're saying, what they're thinking about him.
दरबारमा सबै जनताको लागि कुनै पनि समस्याहरू, कुनै पनि शंका उपशंकाहरू जे भए पनि भन्नको लागि सबैलाई दरबार खुला थियो तर कोही पनि कहिल्यै पनि आएर केही कुराहरू नराम्रो भयो भनेर भन्ने गर्दैनथे. त्यो भएर भगवान् रामचन्द्र आफै नै जनताले के भन्छन् के कसो छन् भनेर आफै बुझ्न जाने गर्नुहुन्थ्यो.
So Lord Ramachandra would disguise himself and incognito, secretly he'd move around and listen to what people were saying. And he came to one place where one barber was living, and he was having an argument with his wife. His wife had gone off with another man and then come home again. And the barber was telling her, I don't want you back here. You're not chaste. I'm not going to be like Lord Ram. He may take his wife back, but I'm not taking you back.
यति यसरी घुम्दै जाने क्रममा रामचन्द्र प्राय आफ्नो भेष छिपाएर यसरी हिँड्नुहुन्थ्यो र एक दिन उहाँ एकजना बारबर हजामको मा आइपुग्नु भएको थियो र उसले आफ्नो श्रीमतीलाई गाली गर्दै गाली भनिरहेको थियो कि तिमी अर्को मानिस कहाँ गएर यसरी आउने हो यस्तो जस्तो उसको श्रीमती चाहिँ अर्को मानिस कहाँमा गएकी थिइन् अनि फेरि फर्केर आएछन्. त्यो भएपछि बार त्यो हजामले अस्वीकार गरेर उनलाई गाली गरेर भने कि होइन म रामचन्द्रले आफ्नो पत्नीसित त यसरी लिनुभयो होला तर म तिमीलाई म फेरि लिन्न भनेर यसरी अस्वीकार गरेको रामचन्द्र भगवान्ले सुन्नुभयो.
Now this barber who spoke these nasty words about Mother Sita and Lord Rama, he was actually a rascal to say such things. So in his next life, he came again in Krishna Lila. And in Krishna Lila, he became the laundryman of Kamsa.
Ra, त्यो जुन हजाम थियो त्यो चाहिँ एक किसिमको खराब पात्र थियो. उसले यसरी नराम्रा शब्दहरू भगवान रामचन्द्र र सीता महारानीको बारेमा भन्नेको त्यो व्यक्ति अर्को जीवनमा भगवान कृष्णको लीलामा पनि त्यो कंसकोमा कपडा लिएर जाने धोबी भनेर आएको थियो.
So Kamsa's laundry man was coming through the streets of Mathura just when Krishna and Balaram had come from Vrindavan. Krishna and Balaram had been living in Vrindavan. And Vrindavan is, you know, the country, it's a village, so you don't get such nice cloth there. And they saw Kamsa's laundryman, who was carrying many nice cloths, pieces of silk, beautiful colored cloths. And so Krishna and Balaram requested the laundryman, oh, you have so many nice cloths. Why don't you give some of that cloth for us?
Ra, tyo jun kamsako dhobi esari Mathura ko sadak ma kapda liera aundai thie bhane Bhagwan Krishna ra Balaram Vrindavan bada Mathura ma hridai garnu bhayeko avastha ma उहाँहरू वृन्दावनमा त्यो गाउँमा त्यति राम्रा कपडाहरू पाउँदैन थियो त्यो भएर त्यो धोबीले बडा सुन्दर सिल्कका राम्रा राम्रा कपडा बोकेर हिँडेको देखेर भगवान् कृष्णले ए यस्तो राम्रो कपडाहरू रहेछ किन हामीलाई दिँदैन हामीलाई पनि देऊ न यस्तो राम्रो लाउन मन लाग्यो भनेर माग्नुहुन्छ
And this laundry man then said to them, don't speak such words like that again. These clothes belong to King Kamsa. If he knows you're talking like that, he'll have you punished.
Krishna Bhagavan like tyo bela ma unle bhaneka thie ki esta naramra shabda haru feri nabhana kina bhane yi kapda bhaneko sadharan byakti ka hainan raja Kamsa ka hun यदि कंसले यी कुरा सुनिसकेको मात्र भए तिमीहरूलाई अहिले दण्ड गरिसक्थे भनेर भन्छन्
कृष्ण रिमेम्बर दिस लॉन्ड्री मैन हु ही वाज इन हिज प्रीवियस लाइफ सो कृष्ण डिसाइडेड बेटर टु किल हिम सो कृष्ण नॉक्ड ऑफ हिज हेड
र त्यति बेला भगवान कृष्णले त्यो धोबी अघिल्लो जुनीमा ती को व्यक्ति हुन् भन्ने उहाँले याद गर्नु भएर अनि उहाँले ती धोबीलाई त्यो पटकमा बरु यसलाई म मारिदिन्छु भनेर उनको शिर छेदन गरिदिनु भयो
So when Lord Ramachandra heard these words, then he went home back to the palace and he immediately ordered, send Mother Sita to the ashram of Valmiki. Now Mother Sita at this time was already pregnant. She was carrying two children in her womb. But still Lord Ramachandra said, send Mother Sita.
र जब ती हजामले यस्ता कुशब्दहरू भनेर भनेको सुनेपछि रामचन्द्र भगवान्ले सीता महारानीलाई वाल्मीकिको आश्रममा पठाउनु भएको थियो जङ्गलमा र जति बेला सीता महारानी गर्भवती भइसक्नु भएको थियो
Lord Rama was so concerned with what other people say that he didn't want to do he didn't want anybody to have any criticism of him
ra esari ramchandra bhagwan dherai savadhan hununthyo ki kasale pani waha ko barema kehi pani esta naramra kura haru nalyaun bhanera esari bado sachet hununthyo
they sent mother sita out and so mother sita while she was staying in the ashram of valmiki she delivered her two sons love and kush and after giving birth to her two sons then she returned to the earth she was born from the earth and she returned back into the earth
ra esari sita maharani le valmiki muni ko ashram ma dui ta putra lava ani kush ko janma dinu huncha ra pachi kalantar ma gaera waha धरतीबाटै आउनुभएको थियो र धरतीबाट नै उहाँ फिर्त जानुहुन्छ
So Lord Ramachandra had no wife anymore. Now as a king, he often has to take part in sacrifices, to perform yajnas and so on. And it's very important that you should have your wife with you when you sit in the yajna. You don't sit alone.
र रामचन्द्र भगवान राजा हुनुहुन्थ्यो र जति बेला राज्यमा यज्ञ गर्नु परेको थियो त्यति बेला सीता महारानीको जरुरी परेको थियो किनकि यज्ञको लागि श्रीमान श्रीमती दुईजनै बस्नु जरुरी हुन्थ्यो
जस्ट लाइक यु नो ब्रह्मा द्याट टाइम ब्रह्मा वाज डुइङ द यज्ञ एन्ड हि वाज वेटिङ फर हिज वाइफ टु कम एन्ड सी वाज टेकिङ अ लङ टाइम And he said, no, I'm coming just now, I'm just putting on my makeup, I just want to paint my face. And then the Brahmin said, the auspicious time is coming for the yajna, she has to come now. Still, she had not come. So then they convinced Brahma, take another wife.
जति बेला ब्रह्माजीले एकपटक यज्ञ गर्दै हुनुहुन्थ्यो त्यति बेला ब्रह्माले ब्राह्मणहरूले अब यज्ञको विशेष मुहूर्त आइसक्यो र तुरुन्त यज्ञ गर्नु पर्यो तुरुन्त यो काम गर्नु पर्यो भन्दा ब्रह्माको पत्नी एकछिन पख्नु पख्नु म आउँदैछु आउँदैछु अलिकति यहाँ अलिक क्रिम पाउडर अलिक पुगेन अझ राम्रो भएर आउँछु भनेर बसेर धेरै टाइम लिनुभएको हुनाले ब्राह्मणहरूले ब्रह्माजीलाई यो विशेष मुहूर्त छुट्याउनु हुँदैन, बरु अर्को पत्नी विवाह गर्नुहोस्, यो यज्ञ यही मुहूर्तमा गर्नुपर्छ भनेर ब्रह्माजीलाई कन्भिन्स गर्नुभएको थियो।
So they got this one girl who was sitting there and they told her, you become Brahma's wife, you sit with him in the yagya. First they passed her through the cow. She became Gayatri, Gayatri, right? One who goes through the cow. And then she sits in the yagya with Lord Brahma. And then Brahma's first wife comes and she says, what? Look, what is this? You've taken another wife? And so then she cursed Brahma.
एउटा केटी थिइन्, तिनलाई ब्रह्माजीलाई स्वीकार गर्न भनिसकेपछि ती केटी गाईबाट हुँदै जान्छिन् र यसरी गाईबाट जानुभएको हुनाले गायत्री उनको नाम हुन्छ र अनि यज्ञमा ब्रह्माजीसँगै बस्नुहुन्छ र यज्ञ सुरु हुन्छ र अनि केही समयपछि ब्रह्माजीको पत्नी आइपुग्नुहुन्छ र अनि ए के हो अहिले अर्को श्रीमती तपाईँले लिइसक्नुभयो भनेर ब्रह्माजीलाई श्राप दिनुहुन्छ।
So the curse was, you will only be worshipped in one place. So Brahma is only worshipped at Pushkar, no other place. We don't find any other shrine or temple to Lord Brahma anywhere in Bharatvarsh except at Pushkar. This was the curse of his wife.
र उहाँको श्रीमतीले के श्राप दिनुभयो भने तपाईँको पूजा सबैतिर अरू कहीँ पनि नहोस्, भएछ भने एक ठाउँमा मात्र होस् भनेर यस्तो श्राप गरेको हुनाले पुष्करमा मात्र ब्रह्माजीको पूजा हुन्छ यो भारतवर्षमा, अन्त काहीँ पनि ब्रह्माजीको पूजा हुँदैन।
But Lord Rama, he ekapatni vrat, he vowed only one wife. And what has happened? His wife has gone back to the earth. His wife is gone. So what to do? So he had deity made of Mother Sita, and he would perform the yagya with the deity of Sita by his side.
तर भगवान् रामचन्द्रको भने बारेमा अर्कै कुरा छ कि उहाँ एक पत्नी व्रत हुनुहुन्थ्यो, त्यो भएर उहाँले अर्को दोस्रो पत्नी यज्ञको लागि विवाह गर्ने कुनै कुरै थिएन। तर त्यति बेला सीता महारानी धरतीमा प्रवेश गरिसक्नु भएको थियो, त्यसैले रामचन्द्र भगवान्ले सीता महारानीको प्रतिमूर्ति बनाएर उहाँलाई प्रतिमूर्तिलाई छेउमा राखेर अनि यज्ञ गर्नुहुन्थ्यो।
Goramandal Parikrama in Navadvip, we do the Parikrama there, we go to the temple Dameshwari. There's a deity, Dameshwari, a deity worshipped by Vishnu Priya, Lord Chaitanya's wife. A deity of Lord Chaitanya, Dameshwar.
Ani. जब हामीहरू गौरमण्डल परिक्रमामा जान्छौँ त्यति बेला गौरमण्डल परिक्रमामा एउटा भगवान्को विशेष विग्रहलाई लक्ष्मी प्रियले पूजा गर्नुहुन्छ, चैतन्य महाप्रभुको श्रीमती हुनुहुन्छ र ती श्री विग्रहको नाम धामेश्वर हुनुहुन्छ।
विष्णु प्रिया वाज अ यंग गर्ल 16 इयर्स ओल्ड। लॉर्ड चैतन्या लेफ्ट होम एट द एज अफ 24 टु टेक सन्यास। And he left his young wife, 16 years old, with his elderly mother. So Vishnu Priya was worshipping this deity of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Dameshwar.
उहाँको विष्णु प्रियाले चाहिँ धामेश्वर मूर्तिको पूजा गर्नुभएको थियो, किनकि चैतन्य महाप्रभुले 24 वर्षको उमेरमा सन्यास ग्रहण गर्नुभएको थियो, त्यति बेला विष्णु प्रिया 18 वर्षको हुनुहुन्थ्यो र अनि धामेश्वर विग्रहको उहाँले पूजा गर्ने र उहाँलाई लिएर हिँड्ने आदि आदि उहाँले गर्नुहुन्थ्यो।
In the Treta Yuga, Lord Ramachandra, he had no wife, he had his wife as a deity. And then in this Yuga, Kali Yuga, Vishnu Priya was there in Navadvip, her husband is gone to take sannyas, she had the deity of her husband, Lord Ramachandra.
त्रेता युगमा रामचन्द्रको साथमा सीता महारानी गइसक्नु भएको हुनाले श्री सीता महारानीको प्रतिमूर्ति मात्र थियो भने त्यस्तै यो युगमा पनि चैतन्य महाप्रभु सन्यास लिएर गइसक्नु भएको हुनाले विष्णु प्रियाको साथमा भगवानको श्री विग्रह मात्र थियो.
One of the islands which we visit on Parikrama is Modadruma Dweep, and it's described that Lord Ramachandra came there with Sita and Lakshman when they were in exile. They had visited there to Navadweep, and they'd seen the beauty of that Modadruma Dweep. Beautiful trees and, you know, nice forests, very beautiful.
टापु आइपुग्छ द्वीप, त्यसको नाम हो मोदद्रुम द्वीप. त्यहाँ भगवान् रामचन्द्र, सीता महारानी अनि लक्ष्मण जङ्गलमा बस्नुभएको अवस्थामा त्यहाँ आइपुग्नुहुन्छ. र त्यहाँको बडो सुन्दर वृक्षहरू र त्यहाँको सुन्दरता देखेर रामचन्द्र त्यहाँ मनमोहक हुनुहुन्छ. त्यो ठाउँमा उहाँ आइपुग्नु भएको थियो.
So it's described in the Navadvip Mahatmya. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur describes how Lord Ramachandra, while he was in this place, he was contemplating, he was smiling to himself. And Mother Sita saw her husband and she said to him, "What are you thinking? What is giving you so much pleasure?"
Teti bela Modadrum Deepma Ramachandra Bhagwan le aipugnu bhaye pachi tya herera रामचन्द्र भगवान् बडो मुस्कानमा हुनुहुन्थ्यो, खुसी हुनुहुन्थ्यो, गदगद हुनुहुन्थ्यो. त्यो देखेर सीता महारानीले भन्नुभयो, तपाईँलाई यो केले यस्तो प्रसन्न तुल्याउँछ, के देखेर तपाईँ यहाँ रमाइरहनु भएको भनेर उहाँले सोध्नुहुन्छ.
And Lord Ramachandra said to his wife, he said, "You know," he said, "I'm thinking how in the future, in the Kali Yuga, we will come here, we will be here in this Navadvip as husband and wife. Just as we are husband and wife now, in the Kali Yuga again, we will come as husband and wife. And I'm going to take sannyas in the Kali Yuga, and I will leave home."
Ra jati bela Sita Maharani ko prashna ko uttar ma Ramchandra Bhagwan le bhanna huncha ki aba Kali Yuga ma hami yahi thama ma aile hami Sriman Srimati bhayera yo Treta Yuga ma aaye jastai tyo Yuga ma pani फेरि आउँछौँ र श्रीमान श्रीमतीको भूमिकामा हुन्छौँ र म त्यो बेलामा सन्यास लिन्छु भनेर भन्नुहुन्छ.
Mother Sita said, "What? You're going to take sannyas and leave me? And you're smiling about it? That's not very nice thing to do."
र सीता महारानीले भन्नुहुन्छ, के तपाईँ सन्यास लिने भनेर चाहिँ मलाई छोडेर जाने भनेर चाहिँ अहिले यहाँ तपाईँ हाँसेर बस्नुभएको त्यो त्यति राम्रो कुरा हो भनेर उहाँले भन्नुहुन्छ.
I'll be left on my own. What will I do? Lord Ramachandra told Mother Sita, he said, "Yes, but by my taking sannyas, by our separation, then our love, our feelings for each other will be more intense. We will experience the pleasure of vipralamba, the pleasure of separation."
र त्यति बेला भगवान्ले भन्नुहुन्छ कि हो, म त्यो बेलामा सन्यास लिन्छु र हामीहरूमा एक किसिमको वियोग हुन्छ र हामीहरू वियोगको मुडमा त्यो भावनामा हामीहरू आनन्द लिन्छौँ भनेर भन्नुहुन्छ.
So another pastime which takes place in relation to Lord Ramachandra in Chaitanya Lila was Lord Chaitanya meeting with Murari Gupta. Murari Gupta was a doctor, Vaidya. He lived very near to the home of Lord Chaitanya, and he witnessed all the childhood pastimes of Lord Chaitanya.
Ra Chaitanya Lila ma ek Bhagwan Ramchandra ko arko katha cha Murari Gupta sanga jodieko. Murari Gupta Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ko ghar nivas sthan najikai basnu hunthyo ra Mahaprabhu ko बच्चा अवस्थादेखिको उहाँले सबै लीलाहरू हेर्नुभएको थियो. मुरारी गुप्त एउटा राम्रो वैद्य हुनुहुन्थ्यो.
And Murari Gupta had a diary all about the childhood pastimes of Lord Chaitanya. And that diary was very valuable for the people who wrote books like Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chaitanya Mangal, Chaitanya Bhagwat. They got the information on Lord Chaitanya's childhood lila from the diary of Murari Gupta.
र मुरारी गुप्ताले चैतन्य महाप्रभुको लीलाहरूलाई बडो नजिकबाट हेर्नु भएको थियो ती बाल्यकालका लीला सबै उहाँले आफ्नो डायरीमा लेख्नु भएको थियो र यसैको सहायतामा जस पछि अरू भक्तहरूले चैतन्य भागवत चैतन्य मङ्गल चैतन्य चरितामृत आदि यसैको सहायताले लेख्नु भएको थियो
सो मरारी गुप्त वाज अ ग्रेट डिवोटी अफ लॉर्ड रामा ही वर्शिप्ड सीतारामा Just like you go on Parikrama, there's a place where his house used to be, and now it's a temple of Sitaram. So Lord Rama, Lord Chaitanya told Murari Gupta that you should give up this worship of Sitaram. Radha and Krishna are the supreme, not Sita and Ram. Sita and Ram, they are just expansions, they are incarnations. The original Supreme Lord is Krishna. You should worship Krishna and his pleasure potency, Radharani.
Ra Murari Gupta le Sita Ram ko Sri Virya ko puja archana garna hunthyo ra waha ko bhakta hununthyo. Jati bela Chaitanya Mahaprabhu le Murari Gupta lai gaera bhanna hunthyo ki timle Radha ra Krishna ko archana garna parcha. Kinabhane Radha Krishna chai purna purushottam bhagwan hununcha. र सीताराम भनेको उहाँको अवतार हो तपाईँले पूर्ण पुरुषोत्तम भगवान्कै पूजा गर्नुपर्छ भनेर मुरारी गुप्तालाई भन्नुहुन्थ्यो
So the whole night Murari Gupta could not sleep. The next morning Lord Chaitanya came to see Murari Gupta and Murari Gupta said to Lord Chaitanya, he said, I will have to give up my life. You have given me an instruction. And I cannot follow it. I should give up my life.
Ra Bhalipalta Bihana Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Murari Gupta Kuma Aipugnu Bhayeko Thiyo. Ra Jabaki Murari Gupta Purai Rat Bhari Sutna Saknu Bhayeko Thiyena Kinaki Ram Chandra Ra Sita Maharaniko Puja Chhorera Krishna Ko Puja Garnu Parcha Bhanne Kurale. Ra Uhaanle Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Lai Bhannu Bhayeko Ki Tapaile Malai Kasto Palan Garnai Nasakne Adesh Dinu Bhayeko Baru Ma म यो आदेश पालन गर्नै सक्दिनँ बरु नसक्नु भन्दा बरु म यो शरीर नै त्याग गरिदिन्छु यो जीवन नै त्याग्नु पर्यो बरु भनेर उहाँले आफ्नो चिन्ता प्रकट गर्नुहुन्छ
Lord Chaitanya was surprised. Why are you going to give up your life? What's wrong? What happened? Murari Gupta said, You have asked me to give up the worship of Lord Rama. I cannot give up the lotus feet of Lord Rama. And you have asked me to do it. So I should give up my life.
र चैतन्य महाप्रभुले भन्नुभयो किन तिमीले यो शरीर त्याग गर्नु पर्यो के भयो यस्तो भन्दाखेरि मुरारी गुप्ताले भन्नुभयो कि तपाईँले मलाई मैले पालन गर्नै नसक्ने यस्तो कठोर आदेश दिनुभयो कि म भगवान् रामचन्द्रको चरण कमल त त्याग्नै सक्दिनँ बरु मेरो जीवन चाहिँ त्याग गर्न सक्छु भनेर उहाँले भन्नुहुन्छ
चैतन्य महाप्रभु told Murari Gupta That's all right. You don't have to do that. You are Hanuman. Hanuman can never give up the worship of Sita and Rama. Even though he knows they're not the Supreme Lord, he cannot go to just Lakshmi Narayan. He cannot worship Radha and Krishna. His heart is sold to the lotus feet of Sita and Rama. So you are Hanuman.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu le Murari Gupta lai teti bela bhannuhuncha ra vastavma timi Hanuman hau. तिमी तिम्रो हृदय भगवान रामचन्द्रको चरण कमलमा एकदम लागेको छ हनुमानले भगवानको लक्ष्मीनारायणको राधा कृष्णको अरूको भक्तिमा मन लगाउन सक्दैनन् किनकि रामचन्द्रमा पूर्ण लागेका हुन्छन् तिमी हनुमान भएको कारणले तिमीले रामचन्द्रको पूजा त्याग्न सक्दैनौ भनेर उहाँले यो भन्नुहुन्छ
सो लर्ड रामचन्द्र रुल्ड द अर्थ फर मेनी थाउजन्ड्स अफ इयर्स And everyone was very happy under his rule. Even today, we glorify the kingdom of Lord Ram. And we want a government like Lord Ram. We want Ram Rajya. We want that kind of government.
यसरी रामचन्द्र भगवानले हजारौँ वर्ष पृथ्वीमा राज्य गर्नुभएको थियो र उहाँको राज्य बडो राम्रो थियो र त्यही भएर आज हामीहरू पनि राम राज्य जस्तो राज्य हुनुपर्छ भनेर त्यस किसिमको प्रशासकको चाहना गर्दछौँ रामचन्द्रको राज्यको बडो गुणगान गाइन्छ
Srila Prabhupada points out, if you want Ram Raja, you have to have Lord Ram. people want the government of Ram, but they don't want Lord Ram. They want the kingdom of God without God. This is the problem.
र श्रील प्रभुपादले यो कुरामा बताउनुहुन्छ कि तिमीहरूले राम राज्य चाहन्छौ भने तिमीहरूले रामचन्द्रलाई चाहना गर्नुपर्दछ र अहिले सरकारमा मानिसहरूले राम राज्य जस्तो बनाउन चाहन्छन् तर भगवान रामलाई चाहँदैनन् यो चाहिँ समस्या हो रामचन्द्र हुनुपर्छ अनि राम राज्य हुन्छ भन्नुहुन्छ
So Lord Ramachandra ruled the world for many, many thousands of years, and then Lord Ramachandra, along with all of his associates, they all entered into the Sarayu River and went back to the spiritual world. Lord Ramachandra has his own abode in the spiritual sky. In Vaikuntha, there is also Ayodhya.
र यसरी हजारौँ वर्ष पृथ्वीमा शासन गर्नु गरिसक्नु भएपछि रामचन्द्र भगवान् सरयू नदीमा प्रवेश गर्नुभयो र त्यहाँबाट उहाँ आफ्नो धाममा प्रवेश गर्नुभयो र आध्यात्मिक जगतमा पनि वैकुण्ठ जगतमा अयोध्या धाम नाम गरेको भगवान् रामचन्द्रको छुट्टै धाम छ
And the devotees of Lord Rama, they aspire to go there, to Ayodhya. They can live there in the kingdom of Lord Rama, in the spiritual sky.
र भगवान रामचन्द्रका जो अनन्य भक्तहरू छन् जो भगवानको रामचन्द्रको धाममा जान चाहन्छन् उनीहरू अयोध्या धाममा गएर त्यहाँ निवास गर्न सक्दछन्
So Lord Ramachandra shows the pastimes of the Lord as a perfect king, as a perfect child, as a perfect ruler, as a perfect husband, everything he does very perfectly. Maryada avatar.
Ra esari Bhagwan Ramchandra le euta purna raja ko bhumika nibhaunu bhayo. Waha euta purna balak hununthyo. Tespachi purna raja hununthyo. Waha euta purna euta adarsha shriman, euta maryada ma basnu bhayeko byakti hununthyo esari aafno purna adarsha ko jivan Ramchandra le dekhaunu bhayeko thiyo.
Okay, any questions?
Kei prashna haru chan ki?
We've only given a little glimpse into the life, the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra. There are many other things could be said.
Ra hamile Ramchandra ko jivan ko barema kei chotkari ma ta batayau aba yaha dherai kura aru pani bhanna sakinthe holan.
Rajendra? Oh yeah, people would say that the pastimes of Lord Rama are very sad. So much lamentation, so much pain and suffering. So.
र उहाँको प्रश्न छ कि उहाँले भन्नुहुन्छ रामचन्द्र भगवान्को जीवनी चाहिँ एउटा एकदम दुःखै दुःखले भरिएको छ धेरै दुःख पीडाहरू यस्तो चिन्ताहरू बोकिएको यस्तो छ यसमा
Yes, Srila Prabhupada comments similarly like that in the Nectar of Devotion. He said that although the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra appear like that, that there is so much pain and suffering and so many difficulties, But there's also the ecstasy, the great pleasure, the meeting the Lord and service to the Lord and ultimately everybody going back to the spiritual sky to be with the Lord.
Ra Srila Prabhupada le pani bhakti rasamrita sindhu ma yo kura ko bare ma bataunu huncha ki Ramchandra Bhagwan ko jivani purai dukha adi le bharieko bhayeta pani त्यहाँ पनि त्यहाँ बडो आनन्द हुन्छ भगवान्को भगवान्सँगको साक्षात्कारमा भगवान्सँगको भेटघाटमा र अनि भगवान्को भक्ति अनि भगवान्को धाम जाने क्रममा जस्तो आध्यात्मिक जगतमा जाने यी सबै कुरामा बडो आनन्द छ त्यहाँ
So we have to see the point of all of this, it helps us to become more conscious, more aware of Lord Ramachandra and his wonderful dealings and his pastime.
Ra, yeah, this is kura kicha bhane भगवान रामचंद्र का विशेष कुराकानी हरु वहाँ का अद्भुत जुन विशेष लीला हरु आदि को बारे में बड़ो राम्रो कुरा हरु छन्।
Yeah, the material world, there is a lot of difficulties, a lot of suffering. The Pandavas also suffered a lot. They were in exile for a long time. And their son Abhimanyu was killed. And then ultimately, they also left the world.
उहाँहरूको पुत्र अभिमन्युको पनि मृत्यु भएको थियो र आखिरमा अन्तिममा यो संसार पाँच पाण्डवहरूले छोडेर जानुभएको थियो।
But this kind of these pastimes, they also have the purpose of giving us some subject matter to absorb our mind in hearing about the Lord and His wonderful activities and His devotees and how the devotees tolerate all these difficulties.
र यी किसिमका भगवान्का भक्तहरूका लीलाहरूले पनि हामीहरूलाई विशेष कुराहरू सिकाएका छन् कि भगवान्का लीलाहरूमा हाम्रो मनलाई कसरी लगाउने र यसबाट विशेष कुराहरू कसरी सिक्ने भनेर धेरै कुराहरू सिकाइएको छ यहाँ।
So it all leads to an awakening of God consciousness.
र यी सबै कुराहरूले हाम्रो भगवान्को भक्ति जगाउनेमा लैजान्छ, जगाउँछ, भक्ति जगाउँछ यसले।
Okay, Ramachandra Bhagavan ki
jai,
Hey, Ramachandra Mahotsava ki
jai,
Srila Prabhupada ki
jai,
Gaur Premanande.
हामी प्रसाद पश्चात केही बेर रेस्ट गरेर हामी ठिक दुई बजे So this one is something. Hare Krishna.